is a presentation of Fox Sports. You see, sometimes in sports, dreamers can dream big, and fairy tales can come true and can even happen to you. Once upon a time, in a faraway land, in a place that is happier than any other in the world, lived an itsy-bitsy little hero named David. And as legend has it, this big old Goliath named Giambi threatened the little tiny haloed hero David. But believe it or not, David would slay the Giambi Goliath, and happiness would return to the divine angels of Anaheim. Meanwhile, in a land of thousands of lakes, the villagers known as the Twins would escape destruction and also do the unthinkable, topple the athletic ones, and march on to the promised land of the postseason. Now in the kingdom of championships lives not one, but two dreamers. But who will move on and try to capture the holy crown of the fall classic and live happily ever after? In baseball, it is okay for dreamers to dream, because now, October magic rules supreme. Next, the Angels and the Twins begin a fall fairy tale on Fox.
Tonight on Fox, the October magic continues as the Cinderella story unfolds in Minnesota. Once upon a time, both teams were expected to be eliminated. The Angels from the AL West, the Twins from the baseball landscape completely. When the final ALCS chapter is written, one will live happily ever after. Hi, everyone, and welcome inside the Magic Castle, a.k.a. the Fox Network Center. Prince Charming here.
Oh,
I'm Jeannie Zelasco. Yeah, that part's already been taken twice over. Cinderella packing a lot of punch these days, though, because the Twins certainly got by the best young arms in the game, and the Angels got rid of the Yankees, something another American League team hasn't been able to do for four postseasons.
Every team believes they play hard and they're intense in Major League Baseball from April through October. Not so. The two hardest teams are the Angels and the Minnesota Twins. They both take nothing for granted. They've come a long ways. The Angels start the season 6-14, 99 wins, defeat the Yankees after losing the first ball game. The Twins, the same thing, almost contracted all the way to the ALCS. They're going to match up against these two teams, the Giants or the Cardinals. These two teams are a feel-good story, the Angels and the Minnesota Twins, two low-revenue ball clubs. They're here right now.
Yeah, the Angels and the Twins have a lot in common besides the fact outside of the confines of their ballparks, few could recognize half of their rosters. They both have perfected the art of doing the infamous little things and believed when others would not give them a chance.
The whole team, we've been through a lot, and everybody has been eliminating us from everything, you know.
You know, everybody's sick of not winning, so everybody kind of just said, hey, what are we going to do to get to that next level? And we all came together and figured it out. You got to play games to win.
We've been able to do some pretty good things here with a good baseball team, but also, you know, they try to get rid of us.
Depends on who you're asking, what our expectations were. If you're asking the 25 guys in that room, the expectations out of spring training were for us to get to the World Series and win a World Series.
I see it. I see that the dream is coming true. Me and Doug McCabe, we sat on the bench one time. We were talking about, man, wouldn't it be sweet if both of us get called up to the big leagues at the same time? Like, yeah, that'll be nice. And next thing you know, we're here. Now we're in the ALCS together.
What I like about the core of these two ball clubs, 65 to 70% of them came through the minor league system all the way to the big leagues. They've played together a long time, both the Angels, guys like Anderson, Erstad, Tim Salmon, all the way back to 1989. 13 years later, he's here. Same thing for the Minnesota Twins.
Yeah, really, for the first time in baseball history, the American League Championship Series features two old-school, scrappy teams with major identity problems. Be honest now, their gimmicks attract more attention than their players.
October baseball conjures up images of heroic blasts, theater on the most historic stages, even a green monster. Never this.
Believe in the power of the rally monkey.
I don't think the rest of the country knows what it's about. It's pretty awesome. It works.
How does the rally monkey help?
You know what? It gets the fans fired up. And, you know, being a West Coast team, that can be hard to do at times.
The monkey alone has found a way to rally the half-calf, double decaf, non-fat, double espresso latte, screenplay writing, aspiring actor, salad-eating, happiest place on earth, sun-worshipping crowd. As long as they follow these simple rules. He can't make an appearance until the seventh inning. At least one Angels runner must be on base before the monkey can go into hysterics. And of course, never stick a rally monkey into a plastic bag.
But I think it's made the difference. I mean, it really gets the crowd into it, and You know, everybody knows what it's like to play in front of an excited crowd.
Like the Middle America masses packed like sardines into the Teflon trash bag line noisy pit, the Mall of America shopping, Paul Bunyan loving, governor body slamming, walleye fishing, Twinkie faithful, see your rally monkey, and raise you a Homer hanky. Okay, it's not original. The hanky was hatched in Miami during the 70s. But the hanky has a twin purpose. Of course, it would be sacrilegious to actually blow one's nose in it. Although it is practical. More than 2.3 million were sold. That's not an aberration. Neither is the ear-splitting noise or the twins' performance this year. So is it primates or Kleenex? We do know this. Both teams' home crowds will be a big factor in this series. Rally monkey, Homer hanky.
Well, I kind of like the monkey. It's kind of cute. Well, if he got that big after beating the Yankees, I'm taking the monkey, I think.
Still ahead, more monkey business here and in Minneapolis, where the Angels and the Twins won't take their eyes off the prize of the ball. There's no such thing as a routine fly in the Dome of Doom. Kevin Kennedy breaks down the matchups next.
Some men are born to be players. Some men are the Mac Daddy.
I'm so glad you finally unblocked my phone number.
Then there's Cedric.
I'm a gay man in a strip club. I really don't care.
Catch the new sketch comedy hit Cedric, returning Wednesday, October 30th on Fox.
For your love, oh, I would do anything. I would do anything.
Get the elegantly redesigned 2003 Saturn L Series for 0% APR for 5 years. For restrictions, see your retailer.
His commitment to public safety and his determination to protect people from crime won him the support of nearly every law enforcement group in California. And this year, with the help of California sheriffs, local police, the Highway Patrol, and other state agencies, he instituted the Amber Alert system. From healthy families to the Amber Alert, to his tireless efforts to improve our schools, for this governor, California's children have been his cause. Governor Davis, experience we trust, values we share.
Wherever in the world you find New York life, you'll find our values. Humanity, integrity, and financial strength guide every product we offer here at home and everywhere in the world you find us. Values that make New York life the company you keep.
As fast as the 03 Toyotas are coming in, they're moving out even faster. Because our 2003 model year lineup is our most exciting ever. Drive home the 03 Sienna van, and you'll get $1,000 factory cash back. Or get $1,000 back when you buy or lease any powerful 03 Tundra. You can even get a special introductory 2.9% APR on the 03 Camry sedan. So here come the 03 Toyotas, and there they go. Just see your Toyota dealer today.
Change up.
You want more than the petty little stuff?
Yeah, it's like
that. I really can't help you with.
So, what are we doing?
Oh, crime.
Crime? Good.
Meet the crew of the Starship Serenity. The tough guy is named Jane.
Do I have your attention?
The hooker is proper.
How's business?
None of yours.
The preacher packs a punch. And the captain is an outlaw.
We're not thieves. But we are thieves.
Out there? Oh, it's out there.
Who are you?
I'm your wife.
How drunk was I last night?
Well, I don't know. I passed out.
Only the creator of Buffy the Vampire Slayer could bring you a future that's this spaced out. Firefly, an all-new episode, Friday, October 18th on Fox.
Welcome back. She may look like the bag lady of baseball, but she plays like the most unpredictable ballpark in the major leagues, and we can hear them from here. Darren Erstad has one on his forehead, another on his right arm. Badges of dishonor that came as a result of a collision with infielder Benji Gill on June 1st at the Dome. When the ball went up, anyone who could see it went after it.
Definite home field advantage. You know, there's no secret to balls being lost in the roof, and just hope that the game isn't decided on a pop fly in the infield that gets lost in the roof.
This is Scott Hatterberg in the series versus the Minnesota Twins right there at the Metrodome. You can't see. This is a baseball up there. That's a baseball. That's a baseball. That's a light. It's white. Why? You can see a football, not a baseball, not a white baseball. But Minnesota has played there. They know how to play there. The best defensive ball club in the major leagues. It's your bad hop right there to Koski against the A's. He makes the play. So does Minkiewicz on the other side. Watch the shortstop. Underrated Christian Guzman. He can fly. Great range going to his left. Across the bag, second base side. Bare hand play. Outstanding. And now take a look at Torii Hunter. Excited to be here. Excited to be playing Major League Baseball. Best center fielder in the American League and All-Star this year. But the offense of the Angels is phenomenal. The Angels down 6-1 against Mussina. Kennedy, forget about it. In the top 10 in batting in the American League. David Eckstein, the X-Factor. He can do it all. Run and hit. He finds the holes. He makes things happen. Eckstein, you got to put him away. Hard to do. Darren Erstad, the human missile. A rocket to right field. This guy can do it all. Base running, defense and center. Hits for power, hits for average. He does it all. Hard playing, hard-nosed ball club. Now, the Angels, seen and not heard in that dome. That's because you can't hear it. It's arm signals, force the issue. Keep that running game going, Mike. And the righties must neutralize the Minnesota right-handed, left-handed bats. For the Twins, let's take the Twins. Be aware of the aggressiveness of the Angels. They'll do everything. They'll tag up on fly balls. Short circuit, David Eckstein and the starters. They have to set the tone. The Yankee starters only went 4-plus innings. They did not get the job done. Therefore, the right-handers, Kevin Appier, got to get some innings tonight.
That crowd got you pumped. It's a twin surprise. The new darlings of the baseball world look to impress and take one step closer to the ultimate vindication. The magical moments continue to unfold next on Fox.
From exactly?
I don't have the slightest idea.
The only way to unlock his past.
Are you saying that you have amnesia but seem to know everything else?
Is to find the clues one crime at a time.
I'd say she's been down here at least 30 years.
Fox Friday, when John Doe investigates a murder 3 decades old.
At the time of her disappearance, she was working for a Stephen Prescott.
The suspect he's chasing.
Can you access DMV records that far back?
Could be himself.
Care to explain how you stayed looking so young all these years?
The deeper he goes to uncover the truth.
Murderer.
The more frightening.
This is starting to paint a really ugly picture here.
That truth becomes.
What's happening to me?
Who is John Doe? All new Friday, October 18th on Fox.
It has to mean something to be a teacher. It's a noble calling. I still believe that.
This is a challenge. Challenges are supposed to excite us.
I can't help her unless she stays in class. Do you even want to stay in school?
Yes. It's a tough job, Ronnie. What do they expect us to do? Tap dance every day?
She claims you called her uneducated.
She was like this irrational, angry animal.
We call them parents.
Why do we do this? It takes up every waking second. We have no lives. Why do we do it?
Because it is our lives.
They're the men and women who change the world.
Society. Tomorrow's world. It starts right here.
One student at a time.
You know, you've kind of inspired a lot of kids here. Leaving your lawyer job to teach, it says to us it's not about money, it's about loving what you do.
The new season of Boston Public, Monday, October 21st on Fox.
A raucous crowd, an electric atmosphere. It's the American League Championship Series from the Metrodome in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Game one between the Anaheim Angels and the Minnesota Twins. Are they ready here in Minneapolis? You better believe it. Hi again, everybody. Alongside Steve Lyons, I'm Tom Brenneman. Welcome to Playoff Baseball on Fox. Who would have thunk it? When the American League regular season, Steve, came to an end, two teams had won more than 100 games, the Yankees and the Oakland Athletics. As fate would have it, neither one playing here tonight.
And you know the two teams playing for the American League crown are the two teams that should be playing for it. Nothing was handed to these two teams. They won games to get here. The old adage in sports, that's why they play the games. And you're going to see in this series two of the most exciting teams in baseball. They will come at you. You're going to see great crowds in both home stadiums as well. And before this series is over with, you're going to see some household names come out of both of these clubs.
Now, their styles are very similar. They're not your traditional wait around for the three-run home run kind of American League clubs. With that in mind, is there an X factor? Does one team have the advantage over the other?
Well, you look at the Angels, and they come into this series as the hottest team in baseball. I mean, they hit nearly 380 as a team when they whooped the Yankees. But the X factor is this stadium here at the Metrodome, the crazy turf. You can lose a fly ball in the ceiling up there if you're not careful. And the strange thing about that is that this stadium can dictate the outcome of a game, and that's not really a good thing.
We're getting set to go. It's game one of the American League Championship Series. Troy Gloss and the high-flying Anaheim Angels. And Torrey Hunter and the Twins sit on the other side. It's game one of the American League Championship Series coming up next here on Fox.
You were bored, so you thought you'd try some kung fu. Here, it's PCS Vision from Sprint. Lots of popular games on the largest all PCS enhanced nationwide network. So now your phone can do more than ever.
Wanna play?
Give me a minute.
Introducing PCS Vision from Sprint. Clearly, a whole new way to look at wireless.
Garrig's farewell speech. Selfless. Robinson's rookie year. Fearless. Fisk's game winner. Timeless. Our pastime. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Devoted fan of Major League Baseball and its most memorable moments.
Pizza!
Gonna be like,
guys, six nights in a row?
Isn't Hell Week over?
Let's go to Subway.
Anything that's not round and greasy.
How about a hot, mouth-watering Dijon horseradish melt or sweet onion chicken teriyaki?
Good luck, man. Thank you.
You call the transporter when it absolutely, definitely has to get there. Alive.
Hi.
In 3 days, get the door. It's the Transporter, rated PG-13.
The League Championship Series on Fox is brought to you by GMC. We are professional grade. By MasterCard. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. And by Sprint. Introducing PCS Vision, clearly a whole new way to look at wireless. Better than 55,000 on hand here at the Metrodome in Minneapolis. Mike Socia's Anaheim Angels, the wild card in the American League, winners of 99 games during the regular season. And let's take a look at his starting lineup. David Eckstein leads off at short, Darren Erstad in center, Tim Salmon in right. Garrett Anderson, the left fielder, Troy Gloss at third, Brad Fulmer, the designated hitter. Scott Spezio at first, Benji Molina behind the plate, and Adam Kennedy is a second baseman. And on the mound, from Minnesota, only won four games due to injury during the regular year, right-hander Joe Mays.
Joe Mays could be the wild card among the Twins staff. They need him big time. Check out the scouting report on Joe Mays. If he's got his sinker working, it's one of the heaviest in the game. Keep it down in the strike zone and it will keep working. And he tries to get hitters to chase his breaking ball and changeup, which are also outstanding if he's ahead in the count.
David Eckstein, a 27-year-old out of Sanford, Florida, looks at a strike, and we are underway. This broadcast also available in Spanish by utilizing the SAP button on your television. Eckstein hit 293 during the regular season, Takes high, one ball, one strike, eight home runs, 63 batted in. You get a look at his numbers during the postseason. 5 of 18, knocked in a run in a four-game victory over the Yankees. Back to the mound. What a way. Let's take a look at Minnesota defensively. Many believe this is the best defensive team in the major leagues. Jock Jones, Torrey Hunter, and Michael Kadire. Left, center, and right. Corey Koski, a Gold Glove winner, down at third. Christian Guzman will win one at short. Luis Rivas at second, and Doug Minkiewicz outstanding defensively at first. A battery of Mays and A.J. Pierzynski. Mays missed nearly 2.5 months this season with inflammation in the muscle and the tendons in his right elbow. Darren Erstad looks at a strike. Many will tell you Mays was among the top five pitchers in the American League a season ago. He went 17-13 and had an ERA barely over 3. But he really struggled his first postseason start this year against Oakland. Came over from Seattle back in 1997, did Mays. Big, strong guy. High and away. Two balls and a strike on Darren Erstad. Kevin Appier will get the ball tonight for Anaheim, making his second start of this postseason. He is the only Angel on the active playoff roster with playoff experience. Little flare into left field. The game's first hit delivered by Darren Erstad.
This is Mays trying to keep the ball down in the zone. Erstad just trying to go with it, go the other way. Off the end of the bat a little bit. There you see the release point of that sinker as it comes off the outside of the fingers. And Erstad knows at this point right here, after he dunks it in over there, there's a potential double if things get a little hairy out there for the outfielders. The ball can squirt through. Ball almost picks up speed on this AstroTurf.
Now the longest tenured Anaheim Angel, Tim Salmon, the 34-year-old native of Phoenix, Arizona. And he takes a strike. Salmon hit 286 during the season, had 22 home runs, 88 batted in. By and large, stayed injury-free this season, something that really has plagued him going back to his Rookie of the Year award in the American League in 1993. Oh, one to Salmon. On the ground, could be a double play. Guzman, Rivas, it is.
Get to the October Power Drive at your local GMC dealer for an extra $500 bonus cash on professional-grade trucks and SUVs. Every new Yukon, Envoy, and newly redesigned Sierra. The power of GMC can be yours with the power of these great offers. Get 0% APR or $1,500 cash back on every new GMC, plus an extra $500 October bonus cash. See dealer for details. Upgrade to professional grade during Power Drive. See the pros at your local GMC dealer before it all ends October 31st.
This is Stacy. This is the dime bag that Stacy bought. This is the dealer who sold the dime bag that Stacy bought. This is the supplier that smuggled the pot to the dealer who sold the dime bag that Stacy bought. And this is Carla, who was hit by a stray bullet from Stacy's supplier and paralyzed for life.
Hiya, honey!
What are you doing here?
I'm taking time for me.
Shouldn't you be at the office?
No, I'm smelling the roses.
Wait a minute. Where'd you go for lunch?
There's something so delicious about Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme with a whole breast filet mozzarella and parmesan sauce.
How was it?
Uplifting.
It takes you and chicken to a higher level.
Good. Now get back to work.
Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme. It's better here. And our pickup window's open till midnight or later so you can eat great even late.
Was it July 4th, 1939, or September 6th, 1995? Was it this defining blast, or his dance of joy? Did you decide on perfection? Did you pick 61 or 62? Was it his catch, his first game, or April 8, 1974? What is the most memorable moment? Watch Game 4 of the World Series to find out.
Baseball Commissioner Bud Selig, along with Minnesota owner Carl Pohlad. Of course, the Minnesota Twins were on the chopping block.
Ooh, the irony.
Talking about Minnesota being contracted at the end of last season, but here they are playing in the American League Championship Series. Their manager, Ron Gardenhire, and his lineup. Jock Jones at left. Christian Guzman, the shortstop. Corey Koski is at third. David Ortiz at DH. Torrey Hunter in center. Doug Minkiewicz is at first. Michael Kadire in right. A.J. Pierzynski behind the plate. Luis Rivas, the second baseman. Kevin Appier on the mound, drops a breaking ball in there to Jones, strike one.
Yeah, I dropped a first pitch breaking ball in there to Jones as well. He's gone deep 15 times in his first at bat. You talk to Ron Gardenhire, and he says, boy, I love it when we start the game 1-0.
In fact, that's the way Gardenhire's very first game as a Minnesota manager went. Second pitch of the game in the season opener, Jock Jones, homer. Gardenhire taking over for the longtime Minnesota skipper Tom Kelly and led his team to the American League Central Division Championship.
Here's a scouting report on Kevin Appier. Tries to get ahead with the fastball most of the time. He knows these guys are very aggressive, so he expands the strike zone with the slider and split finger. This guy will throw a lot of pitches, go very deep into a lot of counts.
Big swing and a miss by Jones, a 27-year-old native of San Diego, taken in the second round out of Southern Cal back in 1996. Took him a little better than 3.5 years to get to the big leagues, but now an impact player for Minnesota. 2-2 from Appier. Popped up. Next time, battling the roof, made it look easy.
Is that the first time you've ever said he's battling the roof?
Yes. Let's take a look at Anaheim defensively. Aaron Anderson, Darren Erstad, Tim Salmon, left, center, and right. Troy Gloss, David Eckstein, Adam Kennedy, Scott Spezio, third to first. And a battery of Appier and Benji Molina. Two center fielders that can really go get him in this series, Erstad and Hunter. Christian Guzman hit 273 during the regular season, 9 home runs, 59 batted in, looks at ball one low. Guzman, 24, hails from the Dominican Republic, was signed originally by the New York Yankees, traded in 98 to Minnesota, along with Eric Milton, Brian Buchanan, and Danny Mota for Chuck Knoblauch. Pretty good deal for Minnesota.
Not a bad deal for both clubs at that time. Chuck Knoblauch came over to the Yankees, helped them win some world championships. This team was looking for some youth. There's the guys, the big name guys that they got in that deal. And boy, have they been outstanding for this club.
Blown away, 2-1 to Guzman. He'll be followed by Koski here in the Minnesota first inning. No score in the game. Appier making his fourth career appearance and third start in the postseason, his second of this postseason. Two hopper, good play by Spezio. He's done a solid job since moving as a third baseman to a second baseman with Oakland, now a first baseman in Anaheim.
Well, I had a long conversation with Joe Maddon, the bench coach of the Angels, and he told me that he thinks the two best first basemen in the American League are playing here. We know about Minkiewicz. You don't know a lot about Spezio, and they said he has been unbelievable over there for a guy who's started as a third baseman, ended up as a second baseman, and pretty much just threw a first baseman's glove on because he wanted to get more at-bats. They say he is as good as it gets over there.
They say the same thing about Koski as a defensive third baseman. Ball one inside. Numbers down this year for Koski. He has battled a number of injuries, hitting at 267. 15 home runs and 69 batted in. Oski, a big home run during that division series and knocked in five in the five-game win over Oakland. Breaking ball missed, and Appier wondering where.
6'3", 220, he's a Canadian, and boy, did they give him a lot of guff about that in the clubhouse. They nonstop pick on Corey Koski. Just because he's Canadian, I guess.
Absolutely, and he acts the play. He played at Canada's highest level of junior hockey as a goaltender and was a most valuable player at the Canadian Volleyball Nationals before deciding to focus in on baseball.
And you know they bury him about that. Now, I'm from Southern California. They play a little volleyball there. They don't play too much volleyball anywhere else unless your name's Susie.
Appier's fallen behind Koski at 3-1.
Ron Gardenhire has said that they clearly expect more out of Koski. They expect him to be a 30 home run type of guy in the future. 6'3", 220, big kid, great defense.
Tardy on an Appier fastball that ran in on his hands. 3-2 to Corey Koski, two down, no one on. Appier has had an outstanding career. He's won 161 games, only lost 127. And a career ERA of barely over 3.5. And in the American League, that's lights out. Pulled into right field, base hit.
You know, Tommy, I cannot look at Kevin Appier for the number of years that he's been in the league and not think of Goose Gossage when you see his delivery. Drop and drive guy, throws a lot of elbows at you. You see gloves, knees, and then a little bit later on, the ball.
Now David Ortiz, a designated hitter, only played in 125 games this year. Still hit 272 with 20 home runs and 75 knocked in. Ball one high and away. Ortiz missed a month with knee surgery. Last year he missed 3 months with a broken wrist and still finished third on the team with 18 home runs. Was the player to be named later in the deal with Seattle back in 1992. Snap throw down to first, and it's in the dirt. Spezio had to pick it out of there. They might have had Koski at first base.
Molina is another one of those guys that's very underrated. Tremendous defensive catcher. A little snap throw right there. Look at Spezio picking and grinning down at first base. That ball gets by him. You can run for days. But I love this. Good throw gets him out, though. Ivan Rodriguez, one of the best at throwing behind a runner at first base. Molina didn't even bother standing up. Just fired it down there from the crotch.
Two and oh to Ortiz. Missed a little low. Appier doesn't appear to be all too happy with Ed Montague, the home plate umpire.
That is pretty nasty right there. Appier's going to want that call a little bit later in the game. Hopefully try to establish himself out there and then move it a little further and further off the plate.
Rio pitch and he pops it up. Short left field. Anderson calling off Eckstein and that'll end the inning. A two-out single by Koski. He's left at first. End of one. No score.
Wow. That is so cool.
Can he do it again?
Sure. Go get one, boy.
Okay, so where does he get him?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Get down! Ah!
The great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Ooh, that's a first.
Make it a Bud Light.
Breaking news from Midas. Right now, get guaranteed lifetime brake pads or shoes for just $39.95, and you'll never have to buy brakes again for as long as you own your car. Next stop, Midas. Lifetime brakes, $39.95, only at Midas.
The heat is on when mozzarella, pepper jack, cheddar, and nacho cheese sauce form a taste to die for. Don't miss the new cheese extreme quesadilla.
Mm, four cheeses.
Four. You've got to be insane.
Forget the rules. In this game, you're the judge, jury, and executioner.
What happens to the bodies?
They just disappear.
Huh. You like the shotgun?
Yeah. Live ain't pretty.
Yeah. I like the laser blaster.
Get you.
I am a soldier. An army of one. Even though I'm a part of the strongest army in the world, I am my own force. And when it comes to me and my team, every link in the chain is strong. I am Sergeant First Class Brian Berkeybell. And you can see my strength.
Yeah! That's what I'm talking about right there, baby!
Hey, what are we gonna do when baseball's over?
Something will come up.
Fastlane returns Wednesday, October 30th on Fox.
Last year, one series rewrote every rule of television suspense.
Who are you working for?
This season, 24 will break them completely.
This cannot leak out to the public.
No! Are you out of your mind?
You need to get out of Los Angeles now.
Kiefer Sutherland, 24, the season premiere. Presented without commercial interruption by Ford. No boundaries. Tuesday, October 29th on Fox.
Set to go, top half of the second inning, game one of this American League Championship Series. No score, Joe Mays on the mound facing Garrett Anderson. Hit 306 during the regular season. 29 home runs, a team high, 123 batted in, carried that right into the division series. Hitting 389, led the team in runs with five and had a couple of doubles. This guy can hit, this guy can play. Garrett Anderson from Los Angeles, drafted in the fourth round back in 1990. An outstanding basketball player and baseball player. Anderson, the first Angel ever, with three consecutive 100 RBI seasons.
Had 123 RBIs 2 years in a row. Funny number to land on twice.
He can land on that for about the next 5, 6, 7 years, and that would be just fine with Mike Socia.
Be just fine with just about everybody, wouldn't it be? Except for every other team in the American League.
Well, we really had a chance to enjoy ourselves both with Mike Socia and Ron Gardenhire earlier today. Two managers extremely pleased to be here, but they feel as though the job is not done. They don't like being called Cinderella. They've gotten here in very different ways, although the team styles are similar.
Yeah, it's like looking in a mirror when you talk about the two clubs. Very, very aggressive at the plate and on the base pass. Good defensive ball clubs. Will make some aggressive mistakes, and neither one of those guys care about that because that's how they'd rather have them making their mistakes.
On the ground to Guzman. One ball. Troy Gloss hit 30 home runs during the regular season. He hit three in the first two games of the division series.
Troy Gloss has a classic home run uppercut swing from the right-hand side, and as long as he keeps that front shoulder in, he can do some serious damage. 47 homers last year to lead the league.
And really, the five through nine hitters are the hitters that did the major damage in a series against New York. When the Angels set an all-time division series record as a team, batting .376. But the 5-9 spots hit .413, six homers, 17 of the 31 knocked in. Troy Gloss, a first-round pick in 97 out of nearby UCLA. And only 26 years old. Oh, to have his future. A Pac-10 home run record. Of course, Mark McGwire played at UCLA's rival, Southern Cal.
I watched Gloss play in college, watched him play shortstop. Could get it done over there, too. As he's gotten into his 20s, got a little bit bigger, a little heavier, 245 pounds. You don't see too many guys like that playing short. Bumped him over to third base, and this guy's a player. Home run production a little bit down, but his RBI and his run production period was not down. Cut his strikeouts a little bit too. 144 of them on the year, but you'd expect that kind of a number from that type of power hitter.
2-2 from Mays. Strike three, or no, ball three. Boy, it looked like Ed Montague was making a turn right to ring him up.
That's nasty right there. Montague strike zone, pretty tight right now, but certainly calling it the same for both sides.
Well, he even pulled out that right hand, and he does it for strike three this time.
Well, let's see the pitch by pitch to Gloss. First pitch, just a sinker right out over. Tried to sneak one past him on the outside. Tried to go out there again and didn't get it. Now, the breaking ball fouled off. Breaking ball nasty on the corner. Says, well, let me catch a little bit more of the plate, and I'll sit him down.
First strike out of the game for Joe Mays. Two down in the inning for Brad Fulmer, the DH. First pitch swinging, drops it foul and out of play. Fulmer began his career in Montreal. Had two solid seasons there, went to Toronto, then came to Anaheim. Hit .289 this year. 19 home runs, 59 batted in. Solid hitter is Brad Fulmer.
His arms are corked. The guy's got some guns on. I mean, this guy is put together right here. His arms are as big as your legs.
Of course, that's not saying much. High fly ball, straight away center field. Routine for Torrey Hunter. And Mays mows him down in order. Hunter will lead off the second. Scoreless in Minnesota.
At Kia, we challenged ourselves to create the perfect midsize SUV. So we loaded the new Sorento with standard features, included a powerful V6, added dual front and side curtain airbags, and a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. But the greatest challenge was to make it affordable. So we hogtied our accountant, threw him in a closet, and priced it under 20 grand.
Introducing the Sorento from Kia. Make every mile count.
Walt Disney presents a motion picture as big as the holidays themselves.
Look out!
Santa Claus is back.
I've got to get married.
It's Mrs. Claus.
Yeah! With all the wonder and magic of an unforgettable Disney event.
I'm Santa Claus.
What?
Tim Allen, the Santa Claus 2.
That's going to leave a mark.
Rated G in theaters November 1st.
I take batting practice. I take infield practice. I take Viagra.
Ready to try Viagra for the first time? Ask your doctor if a free sample is right for you and visit Viagra.com for more information.
Step up to the plate and make an appointment to see your doctor.
Now everyone's excited about Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. Because at Domino's, when you order any large pizza at menu price, you get a second large free. It's Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. Get the door. It's the early week special.
Oh, boy.
For when you need it most. Our longest-lasting Energizer Max ever.
What was that?
Energizer Max. Do you have the bunny inside?
The League Championship Series on Fox is brought to you by Energizers. Do you have the bunny inside? By Viagra. Step up to the plate and ask your doctor if a free sample of Viagra is right for you. And by WebMD, the place America comes for healthcare answers.
Step up to the plate.
Dig in, brother.
I love it.
Torrey Hunter. The most popular player of the Minnesota Twins since Kirby Puckett, they tell us in this town. That one shot into right center field. It's off the wall. A stand-up double for Torrey Hunter.
Here's where a little home field knowledge would come into play. Salmon doesn't chase this ball far enough to the wall. It's hit so hard that you might have been able to hold Hunter to a single. But Salmon's waiting for the ball to bounce off, but it doesn't. You got to track that ball two more steps off the garbage bag because it's not going to bounce back to you. Hunter's doing a little flying of his own around the bases.
First run of the game in scoring position for either team. And now the U.S. Olympic hero from 2 years ago, Doug Minkiewicz. Strike one. Minkiewicz, 28 years old, went to Westminster Christian High School in Miami. Went on from there to Florida State. Mentioned won the gold medal with the U.S. Olympic team in Sydney in 2000.
Birthplace there in Toledo, Ohio. Wonder if he grew up dreaming of playing for the Mudhens. I doubt it.
0-1. Fouled away. The Mudhens never played in the ALCS.
No, they did.
And Kavich, a high school teammate in Miami, Florida, of Alex Rodriguez.
Those guys win anything?
Pretty good.
Wow.
See those numbers by Minkiewicz with runners in scoring position. Ron Geidenheyer told us before the game, said Minkiewicz is made for series like this. He's expecting a big series out of his first baseman.
Big time guy, big game player. Numbers, especially the power numbers, down this year at 15 the year before, 10 this year, but like almost every guy in this lineup, had an injury. He had a wrist problem early on. Not able to generate a lot of power. Hit just 10 home runs this year.
He gets away from Molina. And racing on to third is Hunter.
Molina's one of the best catchers in the American League, but he goes after that one a little lackadaisical. You got to slide over, get your body in front of that. He almost tried to glove it. A la Johnny Bench. There aren't too many Johnny Benches out there. You got to slide your body, get down on your knees, and make sure you block that ball. That ball's going to go back to the screen more times than not.
Anaheim infield plays back. And it's popped up into foul territory. Loss with room. And that's a big out for Kevin Appier. Hunter stays at third, one away in the inning. Take a look at our virtual manager vote now using PCS Vision from Sprint. Or log on to foxsports.com. What's the biggest factor for teams visiting the Metrodome? The roof, the turf, or the noise?
Is there an all of the above?
Well, you played here. Where would you vote? The roof, the turf, or the noise?
To me, it's the turf. The noise you can deal with. There's not a lot of good communication between anybody in any big game. The crowd's always going to be noisy.
Michael Kadire takes ball one in the dirt. Molina, better job blocking that pitch.
The roof is something that you have to deal with here, but you just have to spend a little few more time out there taking fly balls in batting practice and not lose your concentration when a ball goes up. But the turf is a factor that a lot of teams come in here and don't realize how quick it is. And they'll spend that first game of the series with those seams and not taking good routes to a ball that's on the ground.
Infield comes in on the 1-0 pitch, low and away, 2-0 on Kadire. First round draft pick in 97, just outside of Norfolk, Virginia. Spent most of the year in Edmonton, was called up in July. Was a AAA All-Star this year.
They love this guy.
Did he go? They appeal. And no at first, says Mike Evans. 3-0.
In this organization, at the major league level right now, A.J. Pierzynski probably has the purest swing, although he hacks at everything. This guy's second in line. They like his stroke. There's the check swing. In batting practice today, the ball was jumping off his bat.
Infield in, 3-0. And it's taken ball four. It almost appeared like Appier was pitching around Kadire there. I mean, this guy's capable of doing major damage.
Not so sure you want to pitch around him too much to get to this guy, though. There's your average during the playoffs, over 400, a 300 hitter during the regular season. Now you talk about a good, bad ball hitter. Kaczynski's your guy.
A.J. Pierzynski at 300 batting average and was red hot during the division series. Another pitch in the dirt. He had the big one in the ninth inning in game five off Billy Koch.
And they had no idea how big that one was going to be as well. Scored three runs in the inning and then Oakland comes back with three of their own.
First and Hunter broke his. A.J. Pierzynski, a third round draft pick for Minnesota back in 94, grew up in Orlando, Florida. An all-star for the first time this season, led the Twins in batting average and triples as a catcher. Fouled away. Pierzynski, one of three Twins that had that Will Twin against Oakland. Koski, Mankiewicz, and Pierzynski.
A lot of hits and a lot of vowels.
Yes.
A lot of letters in the way in the back half of the lineup there.
He bounced into 14 double plays this season. What Appier's thinking right now. 2-1.
I asked him what Appier is going to try to do to him. He says, he's going to throw slop away, but he's going to try to get me out hard inside, just like everyone else does. And I'm stupid. I'll swing at it. That's what he said. I said, hey, turn and juice one. He says, I've done that before, too.
Hunter at third, Kadire at first, one away, scoreless game. 2-1 pitch. Nope. Throw over to first again. Ron Gardner will tell you that Pierzynski is already one of the top catchers in the American League and will only get better in years to come. And he carries around an attitude.
Yes, he does, and he handles this staff as good as anybody could.
3-1, Appier needing a compass to find the strike zone with some of these pitches here in the second. Luis Rivas waits in the on-deck circle.
And you have the type of windup and delivery that Appier has. Sometimes you can lose focus of where your release point is. Very hard to stay consistent and keep the same release point when you are a big drop and drive guy like Goose Gossage used to be.
Lined into left center field. Erstad will run it down. Tagging and scoring is Hunter. 1-0 Minnesota.
Feeling when you're hitting and you know that the guy's going to try to get you out inside, and in a hitter's count can't go in there quite as well. It leaves it out over the plate and you just hammer it to center.
Luis Rivas takes a breaking ball, strike one. Rivas, a native Venezuelan, signed back in 1995 as a shortstop, moved to second base 2 years ago because of Christian Guzman's arrival at that position. He's only 23. Well, you talk to the people here in Minnesota and they will truly tell you they think this guy is a star of the future.
Young kid, he's going to have to hit a little bit more. They're working on him with that, but defensively doesn't come much better at second base, especially turning the double play.
Check swing, did he go? They appeal again, and no, says Mike Everett. You know, Rivas started 4 of the 5 games in the division series, Steve. He figures to start every game here in the LCS because they are without Denny Hockey, who actually had his finger stepped on and split wide open after the celebration in game 5 in Oakland. Was hurt at the bottom of the pile.
That's the first time I've ever heard of anything like that happening, but I'll tell you what a bad break for Denny Hocking, as the guy's been in this organization, gone through some of the tougher times with this organization, gets his opportunity to move on to the league championship series, caught the last out of that ball game, and then gets stepped on and they have to put him on the DL.
Two one to Rivas. Threw a fastball by him, and again a throw down to first. Goodyear saw it coming.
I think they might want to have Hocking for this series too. He hits .417 against Appier in his career. Had a chance to talk to him before the game. He said, you know what, I'm not going to worry about it. I have my day in the sun. I caught that last out. I'm in the playoffs. I'm going to watch my boys play in the playoffs. Sure, I'd rather be out there, but I still got the uniform on.
Popped up and will drift in amongst the fans. Ron Gardenhire did tell us that should his team reach the World Series, Denny has a pretty good chance to be back.
The problem with the way it was, where it split his finger, it got down into the fingernail as well. And he just didn't think that Hocking would be able to hang onto a bat until at least the weekend. He says there's no way I can go that far into the series and not have an extra body.
Three and two.
Activated David Lamb to take his place. I talked to David earlier today and I said, you're the guy that stepped on him, huh? Because, dude, you're the only guy
who
can benefit from him. He said, no way, man. I had my plastic spikes on. It wasn't me.
Well, you know how to get right to the heart of the story, don't you?
Yeah.
3-2. Pulled foul. There's the runner getting started over there at first base, Kadire. And for a big guy, he can run pretty well. You know, you hear so much, and we heard so much, having not seen Minnesota during the regular season, Steve, that, you know, they were a running team, a National League kind of team. Ron Gardenhire would like them to be more of that kind of club.
Now, I love it.
They don't run as much as everybody thinks they do, I think.
They don't have a good percentage trying to steal bases. They make a lot of aggressive mistakes, and Gardenhire loves it that way.
Swing and a miss to end the inning. But Minnesota gets on the board. A leadoff double by Torrey Hunter. A wild pitch and a sack fly by Brzezinski gets him in. 1-0 Twins.
Got some time to kill? Get bowling, baseball, golf, and more with Get It Now, only from Verizon Wireless. Download games and other cool stuff straight to your wireless phone. Get games, get tones, get going. Does your phone get it? Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
Hello?
Hi, Mr. Johnson. I wanted to tell you that you've won 2 tickets to the Kentucky Derby, 2 tickets to the Super Bowl, 2 tickets to the Tony Awards, 2 tickets to the 2004 Olympic Games, and 2 tickets to the Daytona 500. Mr. Johnson, are you there?
Use your Visa card from August to October and you are automatically entered to win 2 tickets plus expenses to these 5 events.
Take a deep breath, Mr. Johnson. I'm here for you.
Your doctor probably never sees you when you feel like this. This is usually who your doctor sees. That deeply depressed you who barely dragged yourself in for treatment. That's why so many people with bipolar disorder are being treated for depression and not getting any better. Because depression is only half the story. That fast-talking, energetic, quick-tempered, overdoing it up all night you probably never shows up in the doctor's office, right? Log on to BipolarAwareness.com, sponsored by Lilly, on WebMD, the place for healthcare answers. Take the test you can take to your doctor. It can change your life. Let your doctor in on it. In order to make a correct diagnosis, your doctor has to know about your ups as well as your downs. Getting a correct diagnosis is the first step in treating bipolar disorder. Help your doctor help you.
I hope you sit down because I got some bad news. Bernie Mac has been benched.
I tell you what it is, people. It's baseball. They say it's national pastime. Well, God darn it, Bernie Mac is national pastime, too. Yes.
Bernie Mac returns with all new episodes Wednesday, October 30th on Fox.
October's magical matchups continue tomorrow. Both LCS can be seen across the Fox networks. Beginning at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, most of you will see game one of the NLCS, the Giants and the Cardinals. While on Fox Sports Net, it's game two of the ALCS between the Angels and the Twins. For those of you in Los Angeles and Minneapolis, you can see your American League Championship Series game on your local Fox affiliate. So check local listings for the game and channel in your area. 1-0 ball game. Minnesota in front. We open a third inning. Scott Spezio looks at ball one.
That's got to be some kind of baseball paradise when both games are on at the same time, and you've got a clicker with a little jump button. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. You might not ever go to the bathroom.
But
you would.
Yes, I would find a way. Spezio pops it up. Up the third baseline, foul ground, Pierzynski the call, and the catch. Joe Mays looking very sharp early on here tonight. Something he wasn't in his start against the Oakland Athletics in the division series. And Ron Gardenhire went to the back of the team plane and talked to him about what he thought he should do the next go round.
He says sometimes Mays just outthinks himself. The old saying in baseball, and I love this one, my favorite one, no brain, no headache. Don't think, just let your athleticism take over. Let AJ put the fingers down and throw the ball to him.
Ball one to Benji Molina.
Tonight he looks so calm out there on the mound, almost like he's going to fall asleep.
In the air, right field, playable for Kadire. Quickly, two away here in the Anaheim third. Mays made the start in game two in Oakland. Took the loss in a 9-1 defeat, only lasted 3 2/3 innings, allowed 9 hits, 6 runs.
Had an inconsistent year, to say the least, this year. Look at him, though. Is that a guy that looks like he's too uptight about anything? That's relaxation right there.
Off the end of the bat into left field, a base hit for Adam Kennedy. Well, what a solid player Kennedy has become for Anaheim since coming over in the Jim Edmonds deal from St. Louis. Hit .312 this year.
He's taking the ball off the outside part of the plate and going with it. And you can look at that swing, the way Kennedy is diving in towards the plate this way. He's going the other way all day long. Not thinking of anything, but trying to hit the ball right out in that area.
Now Eckstein, who bounced out to Mays, leading off the game. Strike one on the inside corner.
Eckstein's really good and has done a great job this year of trying to poke the ball right into this area after Kennedy's on base. You see the big hole in that area where all he has to do is flip the ball to the opposite field, much the same way that Kennedy did in his last at-bat.
In fact, that was a big part of that 8-run, 10-hit fifth inning to blow it wide open in Anaheim on Saturday. A little hit and run, and there it is. Shot into right field, a base hit by Eckstein, and Kennedy on to second.
Well, that is pretty, pretty baseball. That's National League baseball, and you're checking out the American League Championship Series. Look at the big hole over there. Eckstein's one of the smartest players in the game. All he's going to do is take what you're giving him. He is the definition of the word pest. A guy you love to play with, a guy you hate to play against. You look at him and you say he's 5'8", he's a buck 70, he should be selling shoes somewhere, and he's killing us every day. What a player.
Amazing story as Eckstein was claimed off waivers by Anaheim after spending 3.5 years in the Boston organization. Now Darren Erstad, he singled his first time up. Ball one outside. I mean, it's not like Eckstein struggled with Boston. He had year after year after year of outstanding seasons, came up in Sanford, Florida, walked on at the University of Florida. This guy's felt unwanted for years.
He had one bad half at Pawtucket and AAA in the Boston organization when they tried to mess around with his swing. They had to make a roster move. They decided to take him off the 40-man roster. And the Angels said, we've been watching this kid play. We'll take him. I wonder if there's any good conversations going on there down between Eckstein and Minkiewicz. They had a little thing going on at Florida and Florida State when they were in school. Didn't like each other too much back then.
2-0. On the ground for Guzman. He'll have to play to first, and it goes between his legs, and the game is tied. On to third goes Eckstein. Rivas never came over to cover the second base bag. And perhaps Guzman realized at the last second, Steve, he was going to have to go to first base.
I'll tell you, he just picked his head up on this one, just a little bit lazy on this. Watch him not get down on the ball. He just didn't get his eye level down to the ball there. This is a tremendous mistake for a guy who's a potential gold glove shortstop. Get down, bend your knees, get down on that ball. Just didn't. Thought it was going to be a nice, easy flip little throw. Bad fundamentals.
His team of third fewest errors in a season in Major League history behind the 99 Mets and the 2000 Cleveland Indians. Now you give Tim Salmon a chance with runners on the corners in a 1-1 game. Remember, Minnesota did not play well defensively in game one of the division series. They came back, however, to win that game.
They did have some problems in that series. Very uncharacteristic of this team, because every one of these guys, as you mentioned at the outset of the game, maybe the best defensive team in baseball right now.
On the outside corner, 1-1, they committed three early errors in that game, one against Oakland, but won it 7-5. Eckstein, the runner at third. Darren Erstad on at first. 1-1 to Tim Salmon. Strike two. We mentioned Salmon, the longest tenured Anaheim Angel. The franchise leader in home runs, RBIs, extra base hits.
Rex Hudler, the wonder dog, who now announces the ball games for the California Angels, gave the nickname Kingfish to Salmon. About time someone stuck that one on him.
Two and two.
Dan Gladden, who was a great outfielder in the championship season for this Minnesota team, who also does radio broadcasts for the Twins, says one of the things that this team did better than anyone else, and there is Danny Gladden, we forced them into giving us four outs. We would make them make the mistakes. They have made the mistake in this inning, and it could cost them with Salmon at the plate. We play this stadium so well, and when a new team comes in, I spoke to it briefly, a ball will get hit in the six hole, and the shortstop will start to go for it, but he forgets how quick the turf is, so he takes a bad route towards it. Next thing you know, it's by him, when if he had taken a couple steps backwards towards the ball, he'd have made that play. They don't realize it until game two of a series.
In the air, right center field, Hunter is there, the inning is over. An unearned run scores for the Angels after the error by Guzman. We're tied at one.
Some say he's still out wandering these hills, looking for his lost head. It's a true story.
Okay, time to go to bed.
For when you need it most.
Uh-oh.
Our longest-lasting Energizer Max ever.
What was that?
Energizer Max. Do you have the bunny inside?
At Kia, we challenged ourselves to create the perfect midsize SUV. So we loaded the new Sorento with standard features, included a powerful V6, added dual front and side curtain airbags, and a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. But the greatest challenge was to make it affordable. So we hogtied our accountant, threw him in a closet, and priced it under 20 grand.
Introducing the Sorento from Kia. Make every mile count.
There's a place where I get my favorite Italian sauces, with all kinds of pastas, plus unlimited salad and breadsticks. Sounds like Mom's house, but it's Olive Garden and their never-ending pasta bowl for $7.95. Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
This Friday, you can nab Scooby-Doo on video and DVD. But remember, no jumping, no fighting, and no...
I'll have whatever he's having.
You can own Scooby-Doo on video and DVD this Friday. Rated PG.
So how's it coming?
Good. This one looks pretty exotic.
Cool.
Mosquito net. What was that? Maybe not that exotic.
Great.
Everything you need to choose the hotel that's right for you.
Expedia.com.
It's that time of year when the highly conditioned athlete prepares for battle.
I'm so full of bacon, my body's meant for shaking. And when I start to wiggle, my nipples, they will jiggle.
Once again, I have to be embarrassed for the both of us.
Yep.
Catch the premiere of Malcolm at its new time, Sunday, November 3rd at 9 on Fox.
1-1 game, bottom of the third inning. Minnesota coming up with the top of the order. Chuck Jones down a strike.
Revisiting the error that cost the Twins a run. 12 errors on the season only by Guzman. Just didn't sit down on that ball, get his eye level down with it. Thought it was going to be an easy play, and it got away from him. Then after the play, boy, you love to see that. Joe Mays going over and saying, it's all right, we're going to get it back.
Jock Jones, a free swinger. Ron Gardenhire's been very happy, though, with his season this year, and he knows that he will chase some balls out of the strike zone. But hard to argue with 300 average, 27 home run. This one in the air to right. Back to the wall is Salmon. That has enough room. You have to hit it up above the baggie. There in right field, for those of you that have never seen a game from this ballpark. The big high wall where the truck sits.
You got to get it up over the garbage bag. Everybody looks at that garbage bag out there and they say, boy, that must be a nice fun wall to have to run into. If it's not a big deal, you run into it, it doesn't hurt. Well, about every 6 feet, there's a metal beam that's holding that thing up. And those things are hard. Ask Kirby Puckett.
Ball one to Christian Guzman. There's what you're talking about.
That is a metal beam right in there that's the supports the entire wall. And then where the wall actually gets much taller, they're even closer together.
It's only tall from the right field line to the right center field gap. Two and oh on Guzman. Fouled back out of play. Guzman bounced out to the first baseman Spezio in the opening inning. Both of these teams were expected to be eliminated by now. The Twins from baseball entirely with contraction before the season ever got started. And not many gave the Angels a chance in the stout American League West. When that season began in the AL West, and you know you're competing with clubs like Seattle, coming off a 116-win season. Oakland, a club that many believe was the best team in the American League this year. Here's Anaheim playing in the LCS. On the ground to Eckstein. Two away.
Here's the same ball as you watch Eckstein field the ball. Watch how he sits down on it, gets his eye level way down on the ball, puts his glove on the turf. And by no means am I saying that Christian Guzman is not a good shortstop. We're talking about a guy that made 12 errors all season long. And they're talking about gold glove for Guzman.
Corey Koski had a two-out single to right field, was stranded right there in the opening inning. Koski, 4 of 22 so far during the playoffs, 0-1. Appier going to work. In the air, short right field. And shy of the warning track, Salmon's got it. And a 1-2-3 third inning for Kevin Appier. We go to the fourth, a 1-1 affair.
Sure, all these prescription allergy medicines can pass the pollen test. But what about the pet dander and dust test? Or the smoke test. Unlike these others, only Flonase relieves the nasal symptoms from all these triggers. For best results, use daily. Side effects are generally mild and may include headache, nosebleed, and sore throat. Put your medicine to the test. Ask your doctor about Flonase. When you get it all it takes is Flonase.
Hey, Mom. Just wanted to call and tell you I'm in my new house, and I have every light in the house on. Oh, and tell Dad I'm air conditioning the entire neighborhood.
Every year, millions of Americans experience the joy of owning their first home. Call the Fannie Mae Foundation for a free guide to help put you on the path to home ownership and a list of lenders and credit counselors.
Hey, Vanessa, changing my milk for your apple. Okay.
Hey, Bing, I'll give you $5 for this old phone.
It's not even worth that much.
Right.
Shack, trade in any wireless phone, and get $50 to $100 in mail-in rebates toward a new next-generation wireless phone with color screen.
I waited 30 years to do that.
Vanessa!
Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers.
At Kia, we challenged ourselves to create the perfect midsize SUV. So we loaded the new Sorento with standard features, included a powerful V6, added dual front and side curtain airbags, and a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. But the greatest challenge was to make it affordable, so we hogtied our accountant, threw him in a closet, and priced it under 20 grand.
Introducing the Sorento from Kia. Make every mile count.
The League Championship Series on Fox is brought to you by Kia and the new all-star Sorento SUV, a Kia. Make it every mile count. And by Radio Shack, official sponsor of Major League Baseball. The Twin Cities, Minneapolis, St. Paul. A wee bit chilly when we arrived here yesterday after leaving the sunny confines of Southern and Northern California. About 45 degrees. Upon arrival here yesterday.
And some flakes of snow in the morning. Thank you very much. And I was wearing my golf shirt, which is my winter jacket.
Uh-huh. Anderson bounced out to the shortstop his first time up. This one in the air and playable for Jock Jones.
Couple of the other ground rules that you'll see here in the stadium that you don't see very many other places are these speakers are in the field of play. You can hit a ball that comes all the way up here and hits it. Now, if you're the second baseman, you got to go out because that ball bounced down here. The outfielder would be going deep into the outfield thinking that he's got to catch it. If it hits that speaker, it bounces around out there. You can run forever.
Stay with us for a while. We'll come back to it after Troy Gloss digs in there. A fair ball. Hitting the roof of the speakers. If caught by the fielder, it's an out. But say it hits a speaker and then ricochets into foul ground, it's in a foul ball. And again, those are for the speakers that hang in fair territory. For the ones in foul ground, if it hits a speaker and you catch it, the batter's out, whether you're in foul ground or even in fair territory. But then if it bounces in fair territory and no one catches it, it's a foul ball. So it can be a little convoluted, and perhaps I just messed you up worse than you even knew about before.
Yeah, you didn't straighten out anything.
Nothing new.
Bottom line is, you tell your players to go get the baseball, no matter where it is.
Swing and a miss to Gloss. Good 2-0 off-speed pitch right there from Joe Mays.
This pitch set up with his hard sinker. That just takes him off. A little change there, a little dead fish. Dead fish fastball. I love that term. Just take a little bit off of it. Get a guy out in front. Throw it in a hitter's count.
Took a little off again. 2-2 to Gloss.
Mays throws a curveball and a changeup. Gardenhire would just soon have him throw his curveball more often. He says he has a good slider, but he does make more mistakes with that pitch. He'll hang it every once in a while.
Rolled over that one, down to third. Glove by Koski. Two up, two down. Well, what did you decide? What is the most memorable moment in Major League Baseball history? Watch Game 4 of the World Series on Fox to find out. The most memorable moments are presented by MasterCard. Don't miss it. And one of these two teams will be playing in that World Series. The Minnesota Twins, who have won a pair of World Series while playing in Minnesota since moving from Washington, D.C. You may remember they began as the Washington Senators, one of the first eight original American League franchises. Then Calvin Griffith bought the club, moved him here to Minneapolis in 61. Kirby Puckett helping lead the Twins to World Series crowns in 87 and again in 91. The Angels have never been to the World Series. Roller off the bat of Fulmer. Rivas, not going to be in time. Infield hit for Fulmer. Rivas had to go a long way to get it.
Frankie V. It's Viola right there. Burt Blylevin right there. A couple of other guys in this Twins organization. Oh, killer. Antonio. Rod Carew started his career here. Ken Herbeck went from A-ball to the big leagues, and then Kirby Puckett.
Of course, Rod Carew has his jersey, number 29, retired by both of these franchises.
I hope so.
In the air, Minkiewicz to get it, stomps on the back, and the fourth comes to an end. A 1-1 game.
Sorry about the dust.
Come on, guys, let's go.
After the new roomy 7-passenger Chevy Trailblazer, everything else just seems kind of weak.
I left the bagels in the jet.
The new Chevy Trailblazer, like a rock.
At KFC, we've learned a thing or two about meals. One, this is a poor excuse for a meal. The same old thing, burger, fries, drink. Now this is a meal. It's the Colonel's Big All-White Meat Extra Crispy or Original Recipe Chicken Breast, served hot and fresh with your choice of an individual side, a freshly baked biscuit, and a medium drink for just $2.99. At $2.99, you don't have to be a math whiz to know which deal is the real deal.
Here's another great deal. A big 10-piece bucket for just $8.99.
There's fast food, and then there's KFC.
Michael, you stay and we go to Venice,
I can't. I have a dog.
Stop. Is he kidding? You know, I think his friend Steve back in the U.S. could help him out here. Go!
Hello?
Steve.
Yeah?
It's about Max. Can you watch him an extra week?
Introducing World Class from T-Mobile. Now use your phone worldwide. Get more.
Body pain? Back pain? Now relief is just a shuffle away. Introducing new Bear Extra Strength Back and Body. It soothes aching muscles and sore backs with the trusted strength of Bear Aspirin to work effectively at the site of pain. Plus, a special pain relief enhancer. Nothing works better than Bear Back and Body. Not Advil, not Tylenol. Get moving again, pain-free. New Bear Back and Body.
This fall, Fox invites you to see the world through the eyes of three young attorneys.
I need you to listen to my opening.
Again?
Please, I'm so far over my head on this.
Are you sleeping?
No.
From Emmy Award-winning creator David E. Kelly comes a new series.
This is a murder trial. I at least assumed you'd be prepared.
I was prepared, sir.
He was in the middle of the exam, and he just fainted. He practically gave me a hickey.
Is he cheating on you, sir?
No, he is not cheating on me.
We both know how naive Sarah can be.
I'm not just going to sit back and let her get hurt.
Fox is proud to present the series premiere of Girls Club.
You're ready, and you can do this.
Monday, October 21st at 9, 8 central on Fox.
Twins bat, bottom half of the fourth inning against Kevin Appier. A 1-1 game. Breaking ball, strike one. To the cleanup hitter, David Ortiz, a DH. He'll be followed by Torrey Hunter and then Minkiewicz. Ortiz popped up to left on a 3-0 pitch his first time up. Sharp breaking ball, Deniz, a strike.
Appier has done a great job of getting in on the fists of a couple of hitters. Last inning, Corey Koski and Jacques Jones. Jones with a warning track shot, just enough inside to get in on the handle.
Try to get David to chase there. They appeal down to third. And Larry Young said he didn't go around. Well, they say he did. 1-2. Appier has always pitched well here at the Metrodome. There's a missile in the right field. go-ahead run aboard for Torrey Hunter, who doubled into right center field, went to third on a wild pitch, scored on a fly ball by Pierzynski. And Torrey, a native of Pine Bluff, Arkansas, grew up in the crime-infested east side of that city, where he was telling us roaches and rats shared the house with his family. Sometimes they had no electricity. And in his neighborhood, gangs took over the corners and drugs the currency. But his mom and dad did a fabulous job raising him. We asked him about his upbringing.
Grew up with much and bought a lot of things, a lot of adversity, you know, where I'm from. But I mean, in my hometown, you got a lot of people behind me and in my corner, and everybody's calling me and pushing me on, and I like that. And it was tough coming up, but that's my motivation, you know, to you know, make a better life for my family, and that's what I'm set out to do.
Lays down a bunt, and a throw in time to get Hunter. Excellent play right there by Molina, having to pick up the ball that almost ran right into the bat.
And it could have been like Roger Clemens and fielded the bat instead of the ball. Then he would have had to throw that down to first base or at Hunter. There's the bat out there in the way. Molina picks up the right one and then guns him down. And Hunter can pick him up and put him down, that's for sure.
And there you get an example of the style of this Minnesota team, the five-hole hitter putting down a sacrifice bunt. I'm sure he was trying to bunt for a hit, but ultimately it goes in the book as a sacrifice.
Right, and you'll take that sacrifice right there, maybe get a base hit out of it, move the guy over. National League-style baseball in the American League Championship Series.
By both teams.
Absolutely.
That was the first sacrifice of the year for Torrey Hunter. Ron Gardenhire told us before the game, any manager who tells you he doesn't change his style of play to some extent during the postseason is probably not being honest with you.
You're darn right about that.
Ortiz at second. And it's low and away. Two balls, no strikes to Mancini.
Not that every game during the season isn't important, but when you play 162 of them and you have teams like both of these organizations have, you're looking for guys to, you're trying to put them in situations where they can flourish or fail. You need to find out who can play, who can't. Once you get into this type of a situation, you're done experimenting. You got to reel them back just a little bit. Both organizations, both managers told us that they have talked extensively with their teams about being smart about their aggressive play. But during the season, especially that man right there, Ron Gardenhire, said, you guys go out and play. If you do something really stupid, we'll let you know about it. But as long as you're playing hard and you're being aggressive, we'll take the mistakes right now.
Ball four, look. Second walk in the game issued by Appier. Two on, two out in this 1-1 game with Kadire coming up.
As you might imagine, that Mintkiewicz, with a name like that, has a nickname. They pretty much just call him Mint here. You look at the name on his back, it goes from armpit to armpit. Some people might not be sure if that's his name on his back or a disease.
That says it all.
That's a great one.
Kadire walked his first at bat. First pitch swinging here, a little floater in the right, caught by Salmon. And everybody stays put. So after a four-pitch walk to Mintkiewicz, Kadire first pitch hacking.
I hate to be the guy that sews the letters on the backs of these guys' uniforms, boy. You got your work cut out for you.
High turnover ratio on that gig.
How about the right field Timmy Salmon's playing today? Hasn't been bothered by the roof at all. track down a few balls out there.
Pierzynski has been a money player here in the postseason. A sac fly RBI to knock in Minnesota's only run tonight in the second inning.
By the time you come into the stadium, you love the fact that the fans are here, 56,000 strong, cheering on the Twins after some very lean years after that last championship in 91.
Chase to pitch down, strike one.
Hopefully this run that this team is making might give this area the incentive for a new ballpark, maybe a baseball-only ballpark, because this is a football stadium. And I'll tell you, I come into the Homer Dome here, and I'm constantly looking for, you know, the ringmaster and the three rings and the dancing bears. I'm thinking there might be a circus going on here somewhere. I'm not thinking that there might be a baseball game breaking out. Come here for a tractor pull.
Mm-hmm, they have those too. Two on, two out. Fouled out of play, and Appier gets in front of Pierzynski. Nothing in two. People in the American League that have spent a lot of time coming here or living here will tell you this is a great baseball city. And Ron Gardenhire and Terry Ryan, the general manager sitting right next door, said, hey, look, we've had bad teams. They had eight straight losing seasons until last year. They have great weather here in the spring, the summer, and the early fall. And an outdoor ballpark would be ideal for this area.
If it has an retractable roof.
Right. 1-2.
Back in the time where I was coming here as a player, I used to talk to a lot of people from the Minnesota area that said, hey, we didn't mind going to the old Met. It was cold. We knew it. We're used to it. We're from Minnesota. It gets cold here.
Yeah, maybe you've seen those highlights of Bud Grant. Yeah,
we wear a jacket.
Two on, two out, 1-2. Appier the pause, turns it loose. Fastball away. Big pitch coming up right here. You would assume Appier does not want to go to 3-2 and give the runners a chance to get started.
Well, Appier did a bad job with Ortiz after he got ahead in the count and threw him a good pitch to hit. Appier in this situation, especially with a guy like Pierzynski who will swing at everything, he's got to give him a chance. He's got to give himself a chance to let the Twins get themselves out. They're so aggressive at the plate, you don't have to throw many strikes, especially when you're ahead in the count as the pitcher.
Little floater. Into short left field, and Gloss will run it down to end the inning. Good play by Troy Gloss. Minnesota leads two. We're back to Minneapolis after these messages from your local Fox station.
I'm Christine Devine. Tonight at 10, there's a break in the stalemate at West Coast ports, but how long will this temporary solution last? Then Democrats battle each other as the Senate debates over a possible war in Iraq. That's tonight on the Fox 11 10 o'clock news.
Are you ready?
This fall, my product, it's like getting a personal visit from God.
Make the deal.
The deal is $20 million. The deal is non-negotiable.
I'll take the trip.
I want 10%.
You're negotiating with me?
Blow your mind. Samuel L. Jackson.
Everybody,
Formula 51, rated R. In theaters October 18th.
Today I'm launching my best sourdough jack ever, with juicier meat, thicker, tastier bacon, and my famous golden sourdough bread. Well, time to see what real people think. Hi, I'm Jack.
I'm Wendy.
So this is Wendy's. Where's the drive-thru?
What?
What do you think?
This is very good.
Hot diggity! My best sourdough jack ever gets thumbs up here at Wendy's.
Secession is a gamble that's not worth taking. Round and round it goes. Where it stops, nobody knows. The odds are secession could mean higher taxes and cuts in vital services, fewer cops and more crime. Secession's a roll of the dice that could mean disaster relief won't be there when you need it. Secession's a gamble that could mean higher DWP rates and no rent control. Secession. It's too risky. Don't take a chance. Vote no on FNH. It's too big a gamble.
Wow is right. With Dish Network, you'll get America's lowest all-digital price package. Over 50 channels for just $22.99 a month.
Wow.
Visit Sears or a participating retailer today or call 1-800-333-DISH and ask about our free Dish offer.
Top of the fifth inning we go. Game one of this American League Championship Series. The Angels and Twins even at one. Benji Molina, Adam Kennedy. And then David Eckstein due up against Joe Mays, who's allowed a run on four hits. The run was unearned. Unearned by that man, Guzman, allowed the first run of the game. One gone. We've talked about the Metrodome a great deal already. We asked Mike Socia about his team playing here.
It's tough. We've played six games here this year. You know, you have your battles with balls that go up in the air. The noise will be incredible. But I think you know it's a challenge to keep your focus where it needs to be. I think you're always trying to filter out distractions, no matter what it is during a season or during a game or whatever. You just need a heavy duty filter here, you know, to keep yourself focused. But I think I have the confidence our guys can do that.
These teams, as Mike mentioned, went toe to toe and literally. Toe-to-toe nine times this year as Adam Kennedy takes outside 1-1. Minnesota won the season series 5-4, 7 of the 9 games decided by 3 runs or less, 2 win extra innings. You see Anaheim has played quite well here over the last 5 years. But then again, the Twins last season and especially so this season aren't the Twins of the 3 years before that.
No, they're not. A much, much better club. Everybody knows that. This team did a great job of letting these guys come through the minor leagues together, play at the major league level for a couple seasons, get to know each other, come up together, feel like a family, take your knocks at the major league level. And now they're pretty darn good.
1-2. Into left field again. This one will be caught by Jones. Kennedy had a single that way his first time up. Hit it hard this time, but allowed out.
You know, Mike Socia was talking about the problems of coming into this stadium to play. And to me, the noise is the least of these guys' worries. It's 56,000 people here yelling and screaming, but it's not a big disadvantage to the Angels. They love the fact that there's this many people here coming to see them to play baseball. They love this, that this is the atmosphere they want. This is still the Midwest. These people are nice. It's not like they're playing in Yankee Stadium. I mean, if these people conjure up enough meanness to say something bad about some of the Angels' mothers, you know, it's not like New York where they know where your mother lives.
Right. Strike one to David Eckstein, but you had a chance to play here in front of some big crowds on the artificial surface with the roof. I want to ask you about that when Minnesota comes to bat in the bottom of the inning. Mays mighty good through the front five. A 1-1 game after 4.5.
Silverado is here. Silverado. The truck from Chevy.
You were bored, so you thought you'd try some kung fu. Here, it's PCS Vision from Sprint. Lots of popular games on the largest all PCS enhanced nationwide network. So now your phone can do more than ever.
Want to play?
Give me a minute.
Introducing PCS Vision from Sprint. Clearly, a whole new way to look at wireless.
Championship Series on Fox is brought to you by the Intel Pentium 4 processor. Can a better computer really change your life? Yes, Intel. By Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. And by MasterCard. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Bottom of the fifth inning, Kevin Appier going to work on the number nine hitter, Luis Rivas. And he struck out his first time up. One run, four hits for Anaheim. One run, three hits, one error for Minnesota. And the error allowed the Angels' only run. Christian Guzman had a bouncing ball go right between his legs with two on and two out in the third inning. And Kennedy was able to score.
Brought up the point on that play as well. It was David Eckstein, the runner from first to second. Should have been a nice, easy little toss play to second base for the force out. Eckstein hustling all the way in. And the thought that Guzman might have to come up and throw to first may have rattled him a little bit.
3-1. Even though he's batting down in that number nine spot, we talked about Rivas being injured for nearly a third of the season. He is their best base stealer, according to Ron Gardenine. And he has drawn a walk to begin the fifth. Again, a reminder, tomorrow, both league championship series can be seen across the Fox networks. Beginning at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, most of you will see game one of the National League Championship Series, the Giants and the Cardinals, here on Fox. While on Fox Sports Net, game two of this series, for those of you in Los Angeles and Minneapolis, you can see the American League Championship Series on your local Fox affiliate and the National League game on your local Fox Sports Net affiliate. Check local listings for the game and channel in your area. Barry Bonds and the Giants taking on the St. Louis Cardinals. In the air, left field. Anderson's got it, one away. And Rivas back to first. Let's take a look quickly at our Chevy Trucks in-game box score. And we start with Minnesota. The Twins only three base hits. Pierzynski knocking in their only run with that sac fly in the second inning after Hunter had started the inning with a double.
Appier doing a pretty good job of bearing down when he has to. First hitter getting aboard in each of the last two innings.
We talked about Rivas and how well he runs. And then Jock Jones, as if on cue from our conversation with the Minnesota manager today, first pitch swinging. Not a prototypical leadoff hitter, and never gave Rivas, who has a huge lead, a chance to run. Strike one.
Well, there's not many turf stadiums around anymore. But the determination of what a good lead used to be on a turf stadium is being able to get 1 foot onto the turf. 1 foot in the dirt, 1 foot on the turf. Rivas has almost both feet on the turf.
Rivas coming up through the minor leagues has had stolen base seasons of 35, 28, 34, 31. 31 with the Twins at the big league level last year.
Only 9 this year, but because of that injury, had a broken arm. For as aggressive as this team is, they do a poor job stealing bases. Sometimes Gardenhire has told us, sometimes that's a back end of a hit and run or forcing a guy to run. But they're only successful 56% of the time. Guzman's actually been thrown out 13 times. He's only stolen 12. Jock Jones has stolen 6, been thrown out 7 times. Torrey Hunter thrown out 8 times. He does have 23 stolen bases. Not great percentages for a team that wants to be aggressive. That will change as time goes on and they get better too. Look at the lead that Rivas has now.
2-1. Lined out of the reach of Eckstein. And here come the Twins, 2-1 in a 1-1 game in the fifth.
That's hitting right there. You look where Molina is set up, trying to go inside here, but that ball tails way back out over the middle of the plate. Guzman punching it straight back up the middle. And he's happy that Eckstein's only 5'8". It's 5'9", he catches that ball. Everybody in the Twins dugout right now is yelling at Eckstein, yeah, stay in that hole.
Now the three-hole hitter, Koski, is one of two. A chance to give Minnesota its second lead of the game.
Well, he didn't like that call. There's the pitch, just a tailing fastball on the outside part of the plate, a little bit up as well. It's a strike.
Very good speed on the bases. Rivas at second, Guzman at first. A ball and a strike.
I mean, here's what I'm talking about with Kevin Appier, how he gets a little herky-jerky. Watch him fall way to the first base side after the delivery. Tough to stay consistent within the strike zone with that type of falling off the mound.
1-2 now to Koski.
We told.
Actually, at a much better pace in his start against the Yankees, Steve, where he threw nearly 100 in five innings.
I told you when this one started that he doesn't mind throwing pitches.
Two and two.
Take a look at that pitch. Right out of the hand of Kevin Appier.
Another big pitch coming with a 2-2 count. Pulled down the line. Minnesota has a lead. Rivas score. They're going to hold up Guzman. 2-1 Minnesota.
Appier struggling a little bit with his mechanics and his location. He tried to go inside to Guzman, couldn't do it. This time trying to go away from Koski. That ball started in, stayed out over the plate. Koski just hammers it down the line. You see the big hook on the ball, stayed fair. Rivas off to the races. He knows he's scoring easily.
Runners at second and third for David Ortiz. Strike one. 56,000 plus here in the Metrodome, and it's hard to find any of them using what they paid for, their seat. Big cut right there by Ortiz. It's nothing and two. Ortiz has popped to left and singled to right.
Gardenhire didn't come out and say it, but you get the feeling that David Ortiz is who he wants to be, the key member of the middle of that lineup. He says, we're not going anywhere if this guy doesn't hit.
Guzman at third. Corey Koski knocked in the go-ahead run with a double, is out at second base. Check swing, and he fouls it off. Still nothing at two. Ortiz struggled during the division series. Three hits and 13 at bats, knocked in two runs, did have a pair of doubles. But you're talking about a guy who 5 years ago was the Minnesota Twins Minor League Player of the Year. They have expected big things from him for about the last 4 or 5 years.
Mike Socia says sometimes it's tough to get a particular matchup in a game that you'd like pitcher on hitter, because each guy in this lineup puts so much pressure on you from 1 to 9. Not guys that are going to drill the ball out of the park, but each guy that knows how to swing the bat.
Did he go? They appeal. No. At third base says Larry Young. 1-2 on David Ortiz.
Up and away from Ortiz, looking right down on him. That's not a swing.
Infield conceding the run with one away. Runners at second and third. And a 1-2. Missed low.
This part of the lineup, Tom, too, is exactly what he was talking about. Do you pitch carefully to Ortiz? And if you do, you get Torrey Hunter with 29 home runs. After that, then Kavich. Nowhere to hide.
The 2-2 pitch. Popped up. And playable and foul ground for Spezia. A big out for Kevin Appier. It's his second out of the inning.
Well, you got to be impressed with what Appier is doing. I think he has been struggling with his release point a little bit in this inning. Been behind in the count. And then he comes up with a pitch right there that just gets severely in Ortiz's kitchen right there. Right off, that thing was off his knuckles. Look at the location of this pitch. Get in. That hurts when you get that far in.
Now Torrey Hunter. He doubled into right center field, leading off the second inning. Moved to third on a wild pitch. Scored on a fly ball by Pierzynski. And then laid down a bunt, advancing Ortiz to second base in the fourth.
That guy's putting the whammy on him.
The Thunderdome indeed can be a scary place to visit, especially in October. The leadoff walk has hurt Appier here in the fifth. He walked Rivas. Allowed a one-out single, then a one-out double. And here's Hunter. Outstanding block on that pitch in the dirt by Benji Molina. For the time being, anyway, he saved a run.
This is a 55-foot pitch right there. That's one of the toughest ones to block as a catcher. That's the way you get it done. Drop to your knees. Put your glove between your legs to make sure it doesn't get through that hole there. That's the Molina that the Angels have seen all year long.
Christian Guzman stands at third. Corey Koski at second. Two away for Hunter. 2-0.
Tommy, more than anything else, what that pitch does, the pitch that Molina blocked, gives Appier a lot of confidence that if he gets ahead in the count and he needs a strikeout, he can bounce his split finger or he can bounce a slider in the dirt and try to get a guy chase it. And he knows that Molina's going to block it and nobody can score from third base. Pitcher has to have confidence in his catcher that he's going to knock the ball down.
2-0. Rolled over foul. You got to look at Brendan Donnelly getting loose in the Anaheim bullpen. Anaheim had the best bullpen ERA-wise in the American League this season. Second best in the major leagues to Atlanta. Good breaking ball had Hunter Fuhl. Two balls, two strikes. Hunter, the entire package coming together for this all-star in center field this season. Look at the numbers for the big game, Torrey Hunter.
Quickly on his way to becoming a 30-30 guy. Speed and power, can't teach it.
The thing you love about Hunter even more is he is a fabulous defender.
Even more so in this ballpark. We've talked and we'll talk many more times about the quirkiness of this place. As an outfielder, the Metrodome can take away your aggressiveness. It can take away your great instincts to play the game because you can't turn and run on a ball and take your eye off of it. Imagine Torrey Hunter winning a gold glove as he did last year, playing in one of the toughest stadiums to be a great center fielder.
Three, two. Got him swinging. The ball gets away, but Molina will chase and fire down to first, and that'll end the inning. So Appier, after allowing a run, had runners at second and third, one out, no further damage. It's a one-run Minnesota lead.
Gehrig's farewell speech. Selfless. Robinson's rookie year. Fearless. Fisk's game winner. Timeless. Our pastime. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Devoted fan of Major League Baseball and its most memorable moments.
Oh, boy. Uh-oh.
For when you need it most.
Uh-oh.
Our longest-lasting Energizer Max ever.
What was that?
Energizer Max. Do you have the bunny inside?
Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme is so delicious with its two slices of mozzarella and parmesan sauce on our whole breast filet. It's taking people to a higher level. Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme. It's better here.
I don't think you should hang the bug zapper over the Bud Light. That's really tacky.
Yeah.
Great party. Thank you.
Yeah, this dip is fantastic.
Great. Mm. I love these crunchy things on top. Are they caraway seeds?
Yes.
I didn't put anything on the dip.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Great party, guys.
Fun.
Make it a Bud Light.
Championship Series on Fox is brought to you by Bud Light for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down. Make it a Bud Light. Tom Brenneman, Steve Lyons, our entire Fox crew, elated to be with you here in Game 1 of this American League Championship Series from the Metrodome in Minneapolis. There are so many fans in this area that, as you can well imagine, were so upset at the idea of there no longer being such a thing as the Minnesota Twins. When 2 days after last year's dramatic World Series, it was announced that Minnesota would fall to contraction as it's ball one high to Darren Erstad. One and one. And it really was Carl Pohlad's idea to go along with the program, the owner of the Twins, sitting next to Bud Selig.
Bud Selig's got some good ribs up there.
Well, we know one thing. They taste even better when they're free. Swing and a miss by Erstad.
Well, it should be pointed out as well that a lot of people look at Bud Selig as the bad guy in that whole situation, wanting to contract the Minnesota organization that had been a proud franchise. But it should also be mentioned that Carl Pohlad was all for it and was looking at a hefty going away fee of about $250 million to take the contraction and was happy to do it.
Swinging a foul ball back out of play. It's still 1-2 on Erstad. Thankfully, it never came to that, nor will it for the foreseeable future anyway. With a new labor agreement reached between ownership and the Players Association, they're going to try and eventually get a new ballpark here in Minnesota. We'll see.
We'll be hearing the term of large market, small market as much as we used to. The new revenue sharing program that's going to be in place. We're talking about $61 million payroll for the Twins, which are for the Angels. Certainly not a high payroll, and the Twins way down there. One of the lowest.
1-2 pitch. Taking outside. In fact, only three teams are spending less money on their payroll than these Minnesota Twins. You get a look at the homegrown talent on each of these rosters. Big time number. Very little playoff experience, even for the managers of these teams. And the payroll rank Anaheim 15, 27 for Minnesota. This is what baseball eventually wants. And if you come to this city on this night or go to Anaheim last weekend during the division series, to be completely blunt about it, it's what baseball needs. Baseball fans need to know that sooner or later their team has a chance to win. Two, two. Popped up. Right side of the infield. Mankiewicz will wave off Rivas. And some may be saying, oh, wait a minute now. You know, that plan didn't go into effect to get these teams today where they are. And you would be right. The problem in baseball, or at least those in small to mid-markets, contend, and they're exactly right. It might happen 1 year, it might happen 2 years, but sooner or later, you're going to be unable to keep the Torrey Hunters and the Jock Joneses and the Joe Mays and the Eric Miltons around as a group together.
And there's a big difference between spending a lot of money and spending your money wisely. And these two organizations have done an outstanding job of spending their money wisely.
Yep. And drafting well, scouting well.
Drafting well, scouting well, growing their players from within the way the Twins did it.
Tim Salmon, a homegrown talent. We talked about it over the weekend. Salmon played at Grand Canyon University, a fabulous baseball program at a small Baptist school in Phoenix, Arizona, where the baseball coach, Gil Stafford, is now the president of the university. Check swing, and did Salmon go around? He did.
Well, one of the knocks on Tim Salmon is that you can't expend his strike zone if you get ahead of him. Sliders down in the dirt, bad pitches away. Sometimes he'll chase.
Two down the inning for Garrett Anderson. But Mays has done a remarkable job quieting this Anaheim Angels offense. Swing and a miss, nothing and two. You're talking about a team, as we brought up early, that scored 31 runs on 56 hits, clubbed 9 home runs in a 4-game series against the Yankees. And now the crowd getting behind Mays to mow him down in the sixth. Hard hit ball, Rivas to the turf.
So that's accounting. And down here.
It's the first day of our Dell internship. We're on the tour.
And this is the call center. This is where our customers call.
Excuse me, Lisa?
Yes.
I have an idea. Wouldn't it be great if when people call in, we help them get exactly the right PC?
Yeah, we'd ask them what they were going to use it for. Email, burning CDs.
So they wouldn't buy stuff they don't need.
We'd build their perfect PC at the perfect price. We could even do it on the website.
It would be totally better than going to the store.
Yeah, and the phone number could be 1-800. They already do that.
Get America's favorite PC, like a Dimension desktop for just $699. Featuring an Intel Pentium 4 processor that delivers awesome performance for today's digital entertainment, recording music, sharing photos, gaming, and beyond. And for limited time, you'll get free shipping. Get great deals on notebooks, too. Dude, you're getting a Dell.
Hey, guys, maybe in here they can put in snacks.
When you want your perfect PC, it's easy as Dell. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
I don't know how you do it. I really don't. I put together some really impressive deals. But this thing you've pulled off, it's amazing. A big and tasty for just a dollar? How do you do it? What's your secret? You're a man of few words. I like that.
Got a buck? You're in luck. Because you can get a delicious, beefy, big and tasty or a McChicken sandwich for just a dollar. Every day at McDonald's.
Purple. Very, very powerful.
A shift can change a person, a life, the world, or it can simply change the way you move through it.
It has to mean something to be a teacher. It's a noble calling.
They fight to make a difference. They dare to change their world.
I can't really say I've ever had a role model. Well, now I've got one. Thank you.
But this fall...
Rumor has it that the students are planning something.
Their dreams are about to shatter.
This walkout is about the students' power.
This is about outrage.
They're just calling our bluff here. We have to walk.
Student activism directly affects you, the football team.
What do you want us to do, Mr. Goober?
Things need to change.
Not everybody wants things to change. Shut up.
Oh, you shut up.
People, let's calm down.
The new season of Boston Public. Monday, October 21st on Fox.
Here's the play by Rivas. This is a base hit in any other ballpark in America. Rivas, 30 feet into the outfield. The ball gets on you so quick, but you can play so much deeper because it gets to you quicker. Way into right field, making the play and stealing a hit from Anderson.
Mike Socha goes to his bullpen and brings on the right-hander Brendan Donnelly, who had a sensational year. And again, you ask the question, much like this Anaheim team, who would have thunk it?
Yeah, this is a guy who took 10 years to get to the big leagues.
In the air, left center field, Garrett Anderson is there. And one away in the inning.
Donnelly has played for 9 different organizations, including 2 independent teams. He's been released. Given his pink slip, said, we don't want you anymore, go home and do something else. 6 times. His wife's name's Rhonda. God love her. I mean, at what point did she say, come on, let's go find a real job? Boy, hung in there and hung in there, and here he is.
Michael Kadire has walked and flied out to right. It's funny, it's been so many years for Donnelly since he originally signed, as you mentioned, Steve, with the White Sox. His first pro contract, the 27th round draft choice, he signed for a bonus of $5,000. After taxes, it came out to be $3,500. What did he do with the $3,500? He bought his wife-to-be an engagement ring. And you see that chain around his neck? That's the second thing he bought.
And then that was all the money that was left. That's it.
That was it.
And went to McDonald's.
Kadire drives one into right center field. Erstad reading it all the way. Two gone. And really, Donnelly, indicative of this entire Anaheim bullpen, which we said has been best in the American League, second best in the major leagues to Atlanta. I mean, guys that they really just went out, watched them pitch at the minor league level, and then went ahead and signed them. I mean, guys like Donnelly, Shields, and Weber, showing why they drafted out of Duke University.
And maybe the guy with the best stuff in that pen is a guy they didn't even know they had. Spent most of the year in the minor leagues. Rodriguez with nasty stuff.
We'll see plenty of Francisco Rodriguez. Pitched all of five games during the regular season, and that was more than enough to convince Mike Socia, I think we'll put him on the playoff roster.
At one point, struck out eight guys in a row.
Pierzynski takes on the outside corner to strike, and Donnelly coming in throwing strikes. Ahead 0-2, he's already set down the first two.
Well, that's when we talked to Mike Socia about Donnelly today. He said a guy bangs around the minor leagues for 10 years before someone gives him a shot in the big leagues and then has a tremendous year like this. What's the difference? What did he do? He said, you know what, he just started throwing strikes.
And it helps when a batter will chase one that isn't. 1-2-3 for Donnelly. We played six, a 2-1 Minnesota lead back after these messages from your local Fox station.
I'm Christine Devine. Tonight at 10, the Angels battle Minnesota for a chance at the World Series. We're live with local fans. Plus, these crooks give a new meaning to the term breaking and entering. See this incredible video tonight on the Fox 11 10 o'clock news.
Okay, remember, we're just checking out prices.
So no matter what they say, we're not buying yet.
Right. What's running through your veins?
Ice water.
Right. Game face.
So with Circuit City's Price Match Plus, you're covered on price.
Well, take it.
Go ahead. Take it. If you find a lower price within 30 days of purchase, we'll give you back 110% of the price difference. Circuit City, we're with you.
Nice game face.
We didn't even see it coming.
I'm kind of an expert on ska music. So I get this SBC Yahoo DSL. I got a homepage and music pages that tell me about ska. It's got music news, streaming videos, band articles. It's like this thing knows more about ska than I do.
Welcome to SBC Yahoo DSL. It's smarter, it's faster, it's internet that logs onto you. Call now for $29.95 a month.
Welcome to Cat Chat. Today, we're having a tea party. My date is Sebastian. Isn't he handsome? This is Princess Mocha. She's a Pisces. She's engaged to Grumpus Von Puffybottom.
Okay, guys, this is how it's going down. I'm introducing these new taquitos. Rolled, seasoned, shredded beef topped with real cheddar cheese. Try them, or I'm going to run Cat Chat on every game this season.
English muffin, m'lady? Why, thank you, sir.
See you at the drive-thru.
Jack Skellington's back.
At the Haunted Mansion Holiday at Disneyland. It's scary and merry and back by popular demand with new surprises too. The spirit of Christmas Halloween style. It's the Haunted Mansion Holiday at Disneyland.
Better hurry.
Seat belts.
Wherever it needs to go, the transporter guarantees a rush. Three days. Get the door. Transporter, rated PG-13.
Well, we talked about at the beginning of this broadcast that if Joe Mays kept his sinker down, he could really set up the curveball. Look at the over-the-top rotation on his curveball and the biting action. You can see where it takes its dip. A slider would have more of a counterclockwise rotation. You'd see a little bit more of a dot in the center of the ball. That curveball tumbling straight over the top. Nasty.
Mays pitching like the pitcher who was healthy last season and won 17 games. Not the pitcher who was injured with a bad elbow a little more than a third of this year. And won only four games, had eight losses. He only made 17 starts. Mays has allowed one run on four base hits in the run, an unearned run. Troy Gloss 0 for 2 has struck out and grounded to third. 1-1.
Troy Gloss, the fastest Angel ever to 100 home runs in his career.
Off the outside corner with a breaking ball, two balls and a strike to Gloss. He'll be followed by Fulmer and Spezio in the Anaheim seventh inning. Gloss had a pitch to hit there and fouled it back.
Gloss with the classic uppercut home run swing, and he got a pitch to hit and he just fouled it straight back. And look at the balance through the hitting zone, head down and lift and separate right there.
Short left field, Jock Jones near the line, one away. What did you decide? What is the most memorable moment in Major League Baseball history? Watch Game 4 of the World Series right here on Fox to find out. The most memorable moments are presented by MasterCard. Don't miss it. Doing a little work on the glove of Anaheim center fielder Darren Erstad down in that Anaheim dugout. Fulmer has fly to center, had an infield hit on a ball back up through the middle. And again, Rivas playing beyond where the normal infield area would be, where they're playing on grass with a dirt infield. Out in short right.
Stole the hit from Garrett Anderson playing in that same spot. You look at guys that you think are pull hitters. You can play deeper because the ball will get to you quicker. Truer hops on the turf, unless you hit one of the wacky seams where they've replaced turf because of the football field.
2-0. And he rolls over one. Rivas will charge hard. Two up, two down. What an impressive outing so far by Joe Mays. And Ron Gardenhire told us before the game, I want him out there. He's the right guy out there, and I think he's going to come up big. So far, he's right.
When he's on, he keeps the ball down in the strike zone, and that's where he's been all day long. Turns that one over, little change up. Watch that dip to the bottom, and you swing right over the top of it. And if you get anything, you hit weak grounders into the ground.
Breaking ball, strike one to Scott Spezio.
I guess it would be tough to hit a weak grounder in the air.
Yes, it would. And Mays ahead 0-2.
He is going to work. Look at Mays and his demeanor now. Throws a pitch, he gets it back, and he's ready to go. That's a guy with a lot of confidence.
2-2 now to Spezia. More than capable of tying this game up with one swing of the bat. He knocked in 82 runs during the regular year.
Third ball.
Pulled foul. Mays grew up within a couple of hours of old Tiger Stadium. Went to a number of games there during the 1980s. And in 1999, he won his very first major league game in that old ballpark in its last year. Still 2-2.
Got some time to kill? Get bowling, baseball, golf, and more with Get It Now, only from Verizon Wireless. Download games and other cool stuff straight to your wireless phone. Get games, get tones, get going. Does your phone get it? Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
Favre and the Packers clash with Brady and the Patriots. October's magical matchups continue this week on Fox.
Bernie Mac parenting tip number 38.
I don't know why people call them childhood diseases. With all those darn kids always giving them to me. Me. I say the first time they call, lock them in the attic. Better yet, just laminate them in plastic till they reach the age 18. It worked for my Aunt Mabel's sofa.
Got kids? Get Bernie.
It works.
All new Bernie Mac, Wednesday, October 30th on Fox.
The League Championship Series on Fox is brought to you by Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you, and by Nissan and your local Nissan dealer. Tom Brenneman, Steve Lines, our entire crew back at the Metrodome in Minneapolis. We figured on a National League-like style series, and certainly Game 1, Steve, has been that so far. 2-1 ball game after 6.5.
One run game from two teams that are very aggressive, who haven't been able to show that aggressiveness because of two outstanding pitching performances by both starters so far.
Brendan Donnelly on in relief of Kevin Appier. Appier went the front five, allowed 5 hits, 2 runs earned, walked 3, struck out 2, pitched out of a big jam in the fifth. When Minnesota scored a run to take the 2-1 lead, but had runners at second and third with only one out, and their cleanup hitter coming up. A foul out and a strikeout of Hunter ended the inning. Gloves to his left. Good pickup, good throw, one away. go back to the second inning. Hunter had started things with a double, went to third on a wild pitch, scored on a sack fly by A.J. Pierzynski, and then a roller that should have ended the inning right through the wickets of Guzman, allowing Kennedy to score, and then the double by Corey Koski knocked in Rivas, who opened the inning with a walk. And our Nissan game summary, as Steve mentioned, both starters solid. Very little offense, especially from Anaheim. Only four hits in the heart of the order. Quiet. Jock Jones down a strike. Jock 0 for 3 has popped a short, flying out to right, and flied out to left. Former Duke Blue Devil Scott Schoenweiss cranking it up down in the Anaheim bullpen. First trip to the playoffs for each of these managers. Ron Gardenhire in his first year, taking over for Tom Kelly. Mike Socha in his third season with Anaheim. Jones foul tips it into the mid of Molina. And Donnelly has faced five batters, retired all five, including a pair of strikeouts.
This is just an emergency hack by Jones. Totally fooled by the pitch. Out in front, just tries to wave at it as it goes by. A little foul tip there, and Molina hangs on. Donnelly comes right at you. And that is the difference. You bang around 10 years in the minor leagues, didn't really trust his stuff, wouldn't throw the ball over the plate. Finally, someone said, just go after guys. You got good stuff.
Guzman, a switch hitter. 1 for 3 in a game, single to center in the fifth. Low and away, a ball and a strike. No activity, and not surprisingly, no activity in the Minnesota bullpen. Mays has retired 10 in a row since the infield hit by Fulmer in the fourth. 1-2. Down, nobody on, last of the seventh inning. Minnesota, a 1-1 lead. And 1-2 on Guzman. Donnelly okays a sign with Molina. And then hits Guzman.
Donnelly throwing a slider, trying to get down and in here. He just hooks that slider, gets too much of it. Gets a little piece of Guzman's hammy. Bip. That's the kind of ball that gets all meat. It'll leave a bruise, but you're not going to be hurt.
They'll bring on the left-hander Schoenweiss. The face left-handed batting Corey Koski will be back.
How's it going back there?
He doesn't look too good.
Right or left?
Right. Buddy, hold on.
Today, your home is probably your best investment. So today, there's no better time to come to Lowe's. Lowe's has over 7,000 colors and styles of carpet and every kind of flooring you could possibly want. We'll measure, move your furniture, and install, guaranteed. We'll even haul away your old carpet. And Lowe's has low prices every day, guaranteed. That's our promise. Lowe's, improving home improvement.
Use your Lowe's card. There's zero payments, zero finance charges until April 2003.
Breaking news from Midas. Right now, get guaranteed lifetime brake pads or shoes for just $39.95, and you'll never have to buy brakes again for as long as you own your car. Next stop, Midas. Lifetime brakes, $39.95, only at Midas.
Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme is so delicious with its two slices of mozzarella and Parmesan sauce on our whole breast filet. It's taking people to a higher level. Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme, it's better here.
When you're trying to quit smoking, cravings for cigarettes can appear out of nowhere. Nicorette Stop Smoking Gum, used regularly, will help fight them off. If you encounter a really tough craving, you can take an extra piece of Nicorette. With Nicorette, you can keep cravings at a safe distance. Nicorette helps you quit, one craving at a time.
Things you don't want to be late for, like Malcolm season premiere at its new time, Sunday, November 3rd at 9, 8 central on Fox.
One on, two out, Minnesota batting with a runner at first and two away here in the seventh. And Scott Schoenweiss comes on from the bullpen, first pitch in the dirt. And Molina able to knock it down, preventing Guzman from advancing. Schoenweiss, a starter turned reliever.
Some of those numbers don't look that impressive. He did make 15 starts on the season, put him into the pen. His last 30 appearances, he's got an ERA of 1.71, which is outstanding. It's pretty well documented that the Twins don't do that well against left-handed pitching. You gotta almost wonder if Mike Socha is sitting in his dugout saying, boy, I'd really like to put him back into the starting rotation. Schoenweiss was supposed to be a guy who was going to be cemented into that starting rotation.
Well, he made 74 starts in his career before his first relief outing this season. Lefties only hit 202 against him. And the 1-1 on Koski, no throw of the first. Spezio not holding on Guzman, I mean, not by standard definition anyway. I've seen a few teams do this over the last couple of years, play off the bag right in front of the runner.
Ortiz running about 245 pounds. Isn't going anywhere. Guzman, rather.
Koski fouled that one off his front foot. Where's that shin guard there in the plate that comes about halfway over the foot?
I found the reason why they play in front like that too, as you watch this ball bounce right off of Koski's shin guard. Good thing he had it there, or it hurt a lot worse. Obviously he's hit it off there a few times. Kind of got just on the corner of it. Spezio will play just in front with the left-handed hitter, so he doesn't have to move off of the bag and yet can still technically hold Guzman on. We'll have a sign with Schoenweiss. If he wants to throw over there, he'll dart back to first base in time to take the throw. But he's in a better defensive position where he is right now. That situation, generally, Schoenweiss and Spezio will have some type of visual sign with each other so that Spezio doesn't get caught looking for a pitch, much the same way a guy would get picked off by a lefty when he thinks he's going to the plate.
1-2 on Corey Koski, and again Schoenweiss will go to the bat. Paying a lot of attention to Guzman over there. With two away and a big hitter at the plate.
A little bit bigger lead for Guzman now.
Fly ball right field. Tim Salmon near the line and the inning is over. So the Angel bullpen, a couple of scoreless innings. Joe Mays will take the ball in the eighth with a one-run lead.
Honey, you remember when we bought this house, you said we'd remodel the kitchen?
Vaguely. See, the problem is I just don't have the time.
We can take care of the installation for you.
You can?
Countertops and cabinets. What about tile floor?
Well, sure. Floors, garage doors, even a roof if you like.
Guaranteed?
Absolutely.
I could have done this.
I could have.
Doesn't that song just kill you?
Yeah.
Okay. You want to change the last two scenes?
With a Sony VAIO RZ powered by an Intel Pentium 4 processor, it's easy to make your own DVDs. The VAIO RZ with the Intel Pentium 4 processor. Just close my
eyes and I'm with you. I'm gonna cry. And all that I so wanna give you, babe,
it's only a heartbeat away. I'm a Ford truck man, that's all I drive. I ain't got no boundaries, I don't compromise. I'd rather walk 10 miles and beat down on my love than ride around a block in another kind of pickup truck. If you see me on the highway in a left-hand lane, lost on a back road in a driving rain, up past the timberline where the ride gets rough, ain't no doubt my king of the mountains built Ford tough.
Jack Bauer seems to live an ordinary life.
I love you so much, sweetheart.
But sometimes the men chosen to protect us.
Mr. President, we are in the middle of a grave situation.
Are the most dangerous ones of all.
Put it down!
This fall, an unimaginable threat.
This cannot leak out to the public.
An unstoppable man.
You want results, but you never want to get your hands dirty.
An unforgettable new season.
You need to get out of Los Angeles now.
Kiefer Sutherland, 24, the season premiere. Presented without commercial interruption by Ford. No boundaries.
We open the eighth inning. Minnesota 2-1 lead over Anaheim in game one of this American League Championship Series. Orlando Palmeiro batting for Benji Molina. Joe Mays has retired 10 straight batters, 13 of the last 14. The last Anaheim hit was an infield single by Fulmer in the fourth. Dustin Moore now takes over in right for Michael Kadire. Fouled away. There's activity in the Minnesota bullpen for the first time tonight. The right-hander, LaTroy Hawkins. The left-hander, J.C. Romero. We talked about Anaheim's bullpen. Minnesota's bullpen mighty good as well.
Right there. Guys that understand their roles in that bullpen. Guys that have been doing different things with other clubs.
Larry Young says no on the appeal, 2-1. And now 2-2 on Orlando Palmeiro.
Take a look at the replay of that check swing.
Swung on and fouled away. You look at Joe Mason, we mentioned earlier. 17-13 last year with an ERA of 3.16, the third best ERA in the American League, third in the league in innings pitched, fourth in shutouts, fifth in complete games, sixth lowest opponent's batting average. and the sixth fewest hits per nine inning. So, I mean, tonight isn't some kind of a joke or some kind of a fluke. I mean, you're talking about a guy who is a front line number one, if not very good, number two starting pitcher on any staff when healthy. That's been the problem this year.
Health and inconsistency, and I think one led to the other. You have a good outing, you have a bad outing. You have a good outing, you have a bad outing. This has been a good one.
2-2. Struck him out. Third strikeout of the night for Joe Mays.
Sinker setting up the changeup. That's the changeup on the very same plane as his fastball, but coming in about 10 or 12 miles an hour slower. Watch how he gets Palmeiro to be out in front, out on his front foot. Tough to hit that way.
Good solid pitch count number at 96 here in the eighth. Now Adam Kennedy. Big overhand breaking ball is high. Kennedy has one of the four Anaheim hits. This Anaheim team setting a division series record, hitting 376 against the New York Yankees. And they're two deep here in the eighth inning with only four hits. And we're going to have a stoppage in play as some fan runs out on the field. And we're not going to show this fan running around. Those were household names that the Anaheim hitters wore out in that Yankee series.
And wore them out, they did. You're talking about a team average. 378.
Clemens, Pettit, Messina, Wells. And now here's Joe Mays. And he's twirling a four-hitter with an unearned run in the eighth inning. And Mike Socia is claiming the fan was running out on the field when the pitch was thrown. And he's saying, you know, my guy ought to be sent back up there right now and be given another chance. We have to believe, Steve, out of the corner of his eye, that Adam Kennedy might have been one of only what? Two players on the whole field, if not the only player on the field, that saw the fan running from the left field stands out towards center field.
Definitely pick something like that up in your peripheral vision while you're hitting. Left-handed hitter at the box, a guy coming out of the third base line area. Gotten him out of here now, but caused everybody to have to stand around. Of course, Eckstein never is just standing around. Guy's like energy in a bottle.
12 in a row set down by Joe Mays. The third inning, the only inning, Anaheim has had more than one hit. And it took a two-out error by Guzman for him to get on the board. Guzman's way. Eighth spectacular inning for Joe Mays. He's thrown 100 pitches and he's been lights out.
These people are getting answers to the most important questions they'll ever ask. Questions about their health. They're finding those answers in a single place. WebMD. 16 million people come to WebMD every month. They find vital information that used to be scattered in 100 locations, now all in one place. The place America comes for healthcare answers. A place called WebMD.
Jared's here, and he's eating a hot sweet onion chicken teriyaki.
That I can't miss.
Sounds delicious.
I'm on my way.
Subway's hot dinner idea. Delicious chicken teriyaki topped with a tangy sweet onion sauce.
Wow. Look. Ooh.
Subway, eat fresh.
Dentine Ice.
Subway.
Sub-Zero flavor inside. Delicious cold minty shell outside. The gum that puts your breath on ice for a long time. Dentine Ice. Nothing's colder than ice.
Got some time to kill? Get bowling, baseball, golf, and more with Get It Now, only from Verizon Wireless. Download games and other cool stuff straight to your wireless phone. Get games, get tones, get going. Does your phone get it? Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
Get to the October Power Drive at your local GMC dealer for an extra $500 bonus cash on professional-grade trucks and SUVs. Every new Yukon, Envoy, and newly redesigned Sierra. The power of GMC can be yours with the power of these great offers. Get 0% APR or $1,500 cash back on every new GMC, plus an extra $500 October bonus cash. See dealer for details. Upgrade to professional grade during Power Drive. See the pros at your local GMC dealer before it all ends October 31st.
The League Championship Series on Fox is brought to you by GMC. We are professional grade by The Transporter, Friday only in theaters. And by Subway, fresh-made sandwiches on fresh baked bread. Subway, eat fresh. Bottom of the eighth inning from Minneapolis. 2-1, Twins in front, game one of this American League Championship Series. Benji will give way to his brother, Jose Molina, behind the plate.
Pins hit for one Molina, they throw another Molina in there.
Bobby Kilty will pinch it for the designated hitter David Ortiz against the left-hander Scott Schoenweiss. Strike one. Eddie Guardado, the Minnesota closer, beginning to crank it up. Boy, these are the decisions that managers have to make night in and night out during the regular year. And yes, they're important decisions, but oh, to make them now.
He's coming in. That's every day, Eddie. Joe Mays has been brilliant. Gardner is going to bring a stopper in.
Well, he takes down low. Boy, Mays, he's retired 13 in a row. 16 of the last 17.
You want to run him back out there, don't
I'd
you?
Run him out there again.
You know why he won't?
Popped up. Salmon calling off Darren Erstad, one away. Why not?
Two reasons. Guardado, 45 saves on the year. He is your closer. That's what his job is to do, come in and shut down the ninth. The other reason is because the game has become so specialized that if Gardenhire lets Mays go out there and Erstad takes him deep, it's his fault, not Guardado's.
Ben Weber comes on from the pen. We'll be back.
Everyone's excited about Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. Because at Domino's, when you order any large pizza at menu price, you get a second large free. It's Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. Get the door. It's the early week special.
Come on. You can do it. Just 30 seconds of Listerine. Think of all the germs you're killing. Listerine even kills the germs that can cause plaque and gingivitis. See? You can handle it. Germs can't. Listerine. Worth the time every time.
Ford Explorer has been on top of the world for 11 years running. You don't get there by luck. You do it by constant innovation. Like the unbeatable combination of an expansive cargo area with the easiest folding third row seat, a first in its class. It's just one more idea that takes us to a place no other SUV comes close to. Namely, first place. Ford Explorer, no boundaries.
One out, nobody on in the Minnesota eighth inning. The Twins in front, 2-1. And now on a pitch, right-hander Ben Weber.
Finished up the regular season with six straight wins. Suffered a loss in game one of the divisional series.
0-1 to Torrey Hunter.
Then in game two, injured his finger when he tried to barehand the comebacker, ground ball, and hasn't pitched since. Been almost a week. Everyone says he's okay, though. Well, I'll tell you, on this Anaheim relieving staff, glasses are in fashion. Check out a wacky delivery. Scare you a little bit, but
oh yeah. He scared plenty of American League hitters this season. You saw those numbers. Part of this terrific Anaheim bullpen rolled over foul by Torrey Hunter, 1-2.
Check out that delivery again, Tom. Ben Weber. Couple pump fakes as he's driving the lane. And he pretty much just lets it rip.
Hunter gone swinging. Two away.
Oh, you come with that hard fastball and then sink one down in there right on your shin bones.
Weber, his second full season in the major leagues. Told you another guy really bounced around for 9 years in the minors and even went and pitched in Taipei for 2 years. Strike called on the outside corner to Minkiewicz. Tonight after the game, most of you can stay tuned for your late local news. But for a complete post-game report, turn to your regional Fox Sports Net affiliate for continuing coverage in the Los Angeles area.
We talk about the 56,000 people here at the Metrodome that makes so much noise. Ben Weber has triplets. I don't think the noise is bugging him.
No, because it's before 2 or 3 a.m.
His teammate Dennis Cook also has triplets. Two guys on the same team. If they got together, it would just be like the Metrodome.
Pulled over foul. And our old buddy in Arizona, Luis Gonzalez, the proud papa of triplets as well.
It's a lot of triplets.
Yes. Two and two, the count on Minkiewicz, who's 0-for-2, drew a walk back in the fourth inning. Got him swinging to retire the side. Three sensational innings out of the bullpen. Part of the order coming up. Erstad, Salmon, and Anderson. Will it be Eddie Gordano?
I take batting practice. I take infield practice. I take Viagra.
Ready to try Viagra for the first time? Ask your doctor if a free sample is right for you and visit Viagra.com for more information.
Step up to the plate and make an appointment to see your doctor.
If we hurry up,
I'm hungry.
You are not going to believe what I'm looking at.
Got any gummy bears?
What's ever on the shelf there, Chief?
I can't even tell you.
You don't have to tell her. You can show her. It's PCS vision from Sprint. They built the largest all PCS enhanced nationwide network. So now your phone can do more than ever.
And I can send it to her. That's unreal.
That'd be my word for it.
Introducing PCS vision from Sprint. Clearly, a whole new way to look at wireless.
Seatbelts? Wherever it needs to go, the transporter guarantees a rush. 3 days, get the door. It's the transporter, rated PG-13. Introducing the Cheese Extreme Quesadilla. See mozzarella, pepper jack, cheddar, and nacho cheese sauce form a taste to die for. Don't miss the new Cheese Extreme Quesadilla.
So good.
Makes you want to be bad?
Got a long weekend. We're leaving early.
This is good.
A little luck, we'll be there by noon. Latest.
Thanks.
Ooh, backseat. We'll be the only car on the road.
You ready?
Let's go.
This is gonna be great.
Homer discovers the horrors of human cloning.
Before I abandon you, does anyone remember the way home?
I do.
Anybody else?
It's an all-new Simpsons Halloween special, Sunday, November 3rd on Fox.
Top of the ninth inning from the Metrodome in Minneapolis. Game one of this American League Championship Series. A tight one, a good one.
You got your homer, Hanky?
55,562 answer yes, and they begin to chant Eddie. Every day, Eddie Guardado, the Minnesota closer. 45 saves on the season. Strike one to Darren Erstad. He blew six saves out of the bullpen. For this Minnesota club, 43 come from behind wins this year, 22 of those in their last at bat. Up and out of play, 0-2 to Darren Erstad.
Guardado with a good hard fastball. Slider that he'll throw more to lefties than he will to the righties, and a split finger. Eddie generally throws more to the righties than the lefties. Likes to run that slider away from left-handed hitters. Started his career here as a setup guy. Troy Hawkins closing for a while. LaTroy had a tough season. Eddie stepped in and has never given it back. And Hawkins has done much better in the reversed role.
Erstad only 2 of 14 in his career against Guardado. One of the two hits a home run. And he fights it off out of play to stay alive. Nothing in two. Joe Mays goes 8 innings. Allows 4 hits, 1 unearned run. Did not walk a single batter tonight. Struck out 3.
I believe in the closer's role on a ball club. But I don't necessarily think it should be automatic. And that guy pitched a tremendous game.
Retired the last 13 hitters he faced. Bob swinging their staff. Magical matchups continue tomorrow. Both league championship series can be seen across the Fox networks. 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. Most of you will see game one of the National League Championship Series, while on Fox Sports Net, game two of this series. For those of you in LA and Minneapolis, you can see your ALCS game on your local Fox affiliate. Check local listings for the game and channel in your area. One away in the ninth, and now the dangerous Tim Salmon coming up.
Tom, if they were in a different spot in this order, Mays may have gone back out there. But considering Guardado's going to face two lefties in the three batters that he should face if things go well for Minnesota, I think that certainly helped the decision as well.
Good breaking ball, leaving the count. Guardado gave up three runs in the Oakland ninth inning of Game 5. That was after Minnesota had scored three in the top of the ninth to stretch the lead from 1-4 and hung on. Steve, you bring that up about lefty Erstad, righty Salmon, lefty Anderson. Should it go further than that, however, it would be Guardado against Troy Gloss, a right-handed hitter.
You know, the guys that are closers for ball clubs, you can throw those matchups out the window as far as left on right, right on left, because those guys are the guys that you're expecting to get it done against anybody.
Salmon helping Guardado there, chased a fastball up and out of the strike zone. Count is 2-2. Minnesota 12-2 all time in postseason games here at the Metrodome. One of the two losses last week to the Athletics. Full count.
This is where you'll see how much confidence Guardado has in his splitter or his slider. I think Tim Salmon in this situation right here has to guess dead red and come out of his shoes if he gets a fastball.
Got a breaking ball, pops it up into foul territory. Koski near the stands runs out of room.
Krasinski, Koski coming all the way over. Look at Koski jumping up and out of the stadium. Boy, they like to play so much with Koski and give him so much guff during the season. Someone after the game will say, that was dumb. That ball almost missed the almost hit the speaker there. Koski went flying into the wall to try to get it.
Boy, lucky he didn't get hurt. Ball four, the tying run aboard as Guardado walks Tim Salmon with one away. That is the first Anaheim Angel to reach base since an infield hit by Fulmer in the fourth inning.
And that was a great at-bat by Salmon.
Sean Figgins will now come on to run for Tim Salmon, and Figgins can fly. The Anaheim closer beginning to crank it up just in case. Figgins spent almost the entire year except for 15 games down at AAA Salt Lake. Stole 39 bases. And now a big hole on that right side for the left-handed batting Garrett Anderson. Ball one.
Speaking of come-from-behind wins, the Angels, 43 of them.
Popped up and out of play. It's interesting to know that of those 43 come-from-behind wins, we told you 22 came in their last at bat. They had three come-from-behind wins this year against Minnesota. Two of them here at the Dome. Anyone who watched the Anaheim Angels against the New York Yankees knows this team can come back against anybody. But will they against Guardado in the ninth inning tonight?
We talked about the slider to left-handers. He took some off of this one, made it look a little bit more like a slurve, and look at Anderson out on the front foot, flailing away at that one. not nearly the miles per hour on this pitch. There's the rotation, try to pick up a dot. Good deception.
Came back with another one off the end of the bat into right field. And coming on to get it is Moore. And the Angels down to their final out. But they have the tying run at first base. The winning run coming to the plate. The biggest slugger in the lineup, Troy Gloss.
One cool customer right there, Joe Mays. I don't think he's changed his expression since he woke up this morning.
Loss 0 for 3, a struck out, bounced to third, flat out to left. Hit 30 home runs during the regular season. Three in the division series against New York.
Outfielders for the Twins will all play deeper now to make sure that Figgins can't score from first base on any ball hit. Try to make sure that they don't let a ball get past them and roll to the fence.
Mays and out away from his first postseason win. Threw a fastball right by Gloss. Strike one. The Angels scored 31 runs on 56 hits in four games against the New York Yankees. They have scored one unearned run on four hits here tonight. Oh and two.
Well, Tommy, a lot of home run hitters will tell you they just try to make good solid contact. They don't try to hit home runs. Gloss is trying to hit a home run in this situation.
Innings for the Twins in game one. They're a strike away, an out away from a game one win.
Mentioned Guardado threw a fastball right by Troy Gloss earlier in this at-bat. I don't think that he thinks he can do that again. Get him to chase some kind of breaking ball or a split finger down in the dirt.
Came back with the off-speed pitch and Gloss fouls it away. Still a ball and two strikes. First league championship series for both of these managers. And all but three Minnesota players, all but one Anaheim Angel. He started the game, Kevin Appier. Came with a fastball that time and Gloss just missed it.
Gloss has had a very impressive at-bat. He's been on every pitch. Saw the breaking ball, fouled it off. Gets the fastball, he's right on it. If he gets about an eighth of an inch more of that ball, it's bouncing off of someone's homer hanky out there.
Still a strike away is Guardado. Still an out away. Sixth pitch of the at-bat for Gloss. And they pitch out.
I don't see the reason to pitch out in that situation. If Figgins hasn't gone yet, he's not going anywhere. They're not looking to get Figgins in scoring position here. They're trying to let Gloss hit the ball out of the ballpark. It won't matter where Figgins is standing. It's not a big deal to give up a ball right there, though. You're still going to have a confrontation with Gloss. You will eventually get him to swing the bat in this at-bat.
Now Gloss just trying to tame momentarily the 55,562 here at the Metrodome. They're ready to celebrate a game one win. Breaking ball under the knees, three balls, two strikes. Now Figgins gets started. A ball in the gap, he would likely score anyway. He will definitely score on a ball in the gap now.
He can flat out run. He did make a base running mistake in the Yankee series. He cannot afford to get picked off here. He needs to make sure the pitch is thrown to the plate.
Three balls, two strikes. Strike three called, and Minnesota has taken game one.
Tommy Troy Gloss was having an outstanding at-bat right there. He disagrees with this call. That was a filthy slider on the inside part. Give credit to Gordado.
Joe Mays, eight innings, a four-hit, one-run baseball. The only run for Anaheim, an unearned run. Terrific pitching on both sides. And the Twins come away with a one-run win in game one.
Joe Mays bails out Christian Guzman's error for the best defensive team in baseball.
For more information on tonight's game and for the latest information on Major League Baseball, go to foxsports.com. For Steve Lyons, I'm Tom Brenneman saying so long from noisy Minneapolis. Jeannie Zinaz, Alaska, and Kevin Kennedy will be along from the Fox Network Center after these messages. We look ahead to game two tomorrow night. Minnesota leads this series 1-0.
The questions we take for granted are the ones he'd give anything to know.
I need to report a missing person.
You filled out a form 3021-B.
I'm the missing person.
Are you saying that you have amnesia but seem to know everything about everything else?
Ask me a question.
How many M&M's coming up?
Plain 60, peanut 25.
First line of Macbeth.
When shall we three meet again?
Do the phone book again.
White or yellow?
Where did you come from exactly?
I don't have the slightest idea.
This fall.
We have a victim killed within the last 24 hours.
One man will use his extraordinary gifts.
I reverse encrypted their firewall with a pseudo IP and deconstructed a telnet with a viral protocol.
To solve the crimes no one else can.
Was your husband a vegetarian?
No.
Then this is not your husband.
And unlock the greatest mystery of all.
The more bizarre a thing looks, the simpler the explanation.
Who he is. John Doe. An all-new episode. Friday, October 18th on Fox.
I am.
I'm Christine Devine. Tonight at 10, there's a break in the stalemate at West Coast ports, but how long will this temporary solution last? Then Democrats battle each other as the Senate debates over a possible war in Iraq. That's tonight on the Fox 11 10 o'clock news.
When you're at the top of your game, everyone expects you to be powerful. But when you have power, style, and grace, you leave the world in a wake of awe. The new GMC 2003 Yukon XL Denali. You can't fake professional grade.
Right now, get $1,500 cash back or 0% APR plus $500 bonus cash on a new 2003 Yukon Denali or Yukon XL Denali. See your Southern California GMC truck dealer for details. An upgrade to professional grade.
For the crew of the USS Tiger Shark, in the depths of the Atlantic Ocean, there is something much more to fear.
I don't think we're alone down here.
They always thought the enemy would come from above. Nothing could prepare them.
We're going down.
For the evil waiting below.
Mr. Loomis,
in theaters this Friday.
Do you believe the former contraction kids remain on track for the ultimate vindication? Joe Mays, the October magic working tonight.
Well, what you're looking at is exactly what Joe Mays did. This is excellent scouting, perfect execution by Joe Mays, and a credit to the Minnesota Twins. Change-ups in hitters' counts. That's not what the Yankees did in hitters' counts. They went right after these guys, and the Anaheim Angels hit home runs. Not Joe Mays today against the big guys. Great change-up. That's what you're looking at right here. Great arm speed. It looks like a fastball to the hitter. There's the grip. There's that circle change grip. Here comes the arm speed. Bottom will fall out of this pitch right here, right off the end of the bat. Forget about it. That's what the Angels saw all night long. Therefore, no earned runs off of Joe Mays today. He was absolutely outstanding. Guardado finished it off in the same fashion with a 3-2 off-speed breaking ball to Troy Gloss. No earned runs tonight. 8 innings pitch, 68 strikes, 99 pitches. Absolutely outstanding. Joe Mays was a 17-game winner last year. Yes, he only won 4 games. He was hurt for 4 months with elbow tendonitis. Therefore, tomorrow night he sets it up for Rick Reed, who pitches much the same way. Curveballs, two-seamers, change-ups. He'll do the same thing. Ramon Ortiz was nervous in game 1. Perhaps in his second postseason start in his career, he'll pitch much better. I think he will.
All right, let's talk about one of the big swingers. Barry Bonds has his sights set on his first ever World Series appearance. Of course, he has to get by the Cardinals first.
Well, you know what? He's swinging the bat well, as usual, even in the postseason. Kevin Millman went right after him, to his credit. Millman with a 96-97 fastball, 3-2. No changeup from Millman. Fastball, but Bonds is phenomenal. The most dominant hitter in Major League Baseball the last 2 years. He's doing things like Babe Ruth did back in the 20s and 30s. That's what you're going to see tomorrow night. Barry Bonds, San Francisco Giants in St. Louis against a ball club that has struggled, had a lot of highs and lows. It's going to be a great, even matchup. We'll find out if they're going to pitch to Bonds and Matt Morris with that good curveball tomorrow night.
A great matchup in this wild, magical October. There are just 4 survivors, and guess what? They are all scheduled to appear tomorrow night on Fox, the NLCS Game 1 between the Giants and the Cardinals. Game 2 for the Twins and the Angels. 1 on your local Fox affiliate, 1 on your local Fox Sports Net station. Check your local listings. October's magical moments continue to unfold night after night on Fox. Of course, Minnesota worried about lasting until the start of spring training. Kevin, they have outlasted the Anaheim Angels.
It's incredible. I can't say enough to go back to the scouting that the Twins did on the Angel-Yankees series. That's why you saw the off-speed pitches. We'll see if the Angels now make the adjustment.
All right. The Cinderella story continues to unfold. Absolutely. As we look for more October magical moments. Big night on Fox tomorrow night with
two matchups.
For Kevin Kennedy, I'm Jeannie Zalasko. We'll see you tomorrow night.
In the 8th with Eckstein up, inducing him to ground out and kill another rally. Angels had a little something going on in the 9th inning and managed to get a man on of Salmon and Gloss and Anderson. The only time one of those guys got out was the walk to Salmon in the 9th. Sean Figgins running for him, and Rex calls for
him. Hang with him. That's a pitch way too close to take. We've seen Gloss do it in tonight's game twice now. You can't be sleeping at the plate when runners are on base.
The Angels waste a pretty solid outing by Kevin Appier. And when you have that, look at that second line. It says Kennedy, 1-for-3 run. When the offensive star of your team is 1-for-3 with a run scored, not good. All right, some of the key numbers, guys, and you can look at Salmon and Anderson and Gloss, 0-for-11. Big 0-for donut for those guys, hitting 129 tonight against Joe Mays.
Joe Mays, he is the story. Heck, he can shut down that fearsome three right there after a red-hot 376 team average versus the Yankees. You're going to win some games. That was outstanding job by Mays.
Yeah, obviously we're going to continue to, you know, talk about this Joe Mays thing, but he had the talent of Willie Mays out there tonight. But you look at what he did to the Angels tonight. The Angels did not have a leadoff batter on all night long. Only once did they have a guy on base with less than 2 outs. That was the first inning. They did it again in the 9th, but Mays was out of the game. As a pitcher, former pitcher, what's your approach against the Angels, and was Joe Mays' approach the exact right one tonight? Obviously it was, but did it just work out that way, or was there something to be said for that, and can we look for that down the line in this series?
Well, he's the type of guy that doesn't have the luxury of blowing people away. He has to have throwing strikes all day long, hit his spots, changing speeds, and if you saw all night long, the pitches the Angels got to hit, they did not put those in play. They fouled them off, or they popped them up. So the pitches that they got in the Yankee series that they drove for base hits, tonight they missed them, or they they popped them up.
All right, guys, hang loose. We're going to switch now to the Metrodome and check in with our Susie Schuster. Yeah, I know, you're hanging loose there, Hudman. And Susie, what did you see out there tonight at the Metrodome?
Well, I'll tell you, Frick, one thing that I saw in particular was Troy Gloss put a hurting on a garbage can at the bottom of the stairs on the way back up to the clubhouse. Of course, Gloss very frustrated with that called third straight looking. And if you look at the whole heart of the order there, Anderson, Gloss, and Salmon are really not coming up with anything big for them tonight. Now, another thing that I saw, or perhaps better to say is heard, is the 55,562 people that crowded in here tonight were not nearly as loud as I thought they would be. Actually, Edison Field was a lot louder on Saturday when the Angels were able to take care of the Yankees. It's funny, it was a strategic crowd. They actually know when to cheer as to distract the players in the field. For instance, in the very first Twins batter of the game, Jacques Jones, when he popped up to David Eckstein, the crowd cheered the loudest when they knew that Eckstein was trying to get the ball. And of course, the Angels have worked on all week long on signals, knowing that they would not be able to hear anything within 10 feet of each other. All signals. And you saw David Eckstein. Nobody can maybe wave off anybody else like David Eckstein. So you saw a lot of that. The other thing I want to think that you guys might want to talk about, HUD and also Mark, is the fact that you didn't see the same kind of going deep into the pitch counts that we saw against the Yankees. Very interesting. Maybe we could find some more about that when we go inside the clubhouse.
And, of course, we will look for that tomorrow, see how the Angels approach that. Right now, though, Mike Socha stepping up to the podium in Minnesota. Let's throw it back to the Metrodome.
The way he, when guys were on base, the way he made pitches, I don't think he faced, but maybe, what, three over the minimum, something like that. He stepped up and pitched a great game. He changed speeds well, worked in and out. We really, you know, we couldn't get a lot of things going. Obviously, when you're not getting any leadoff guys on in an inning, it makes it tough. And he pitched a terrific game. You know, that's one of the best games we've had pitched against us all year.
Another one? Another question. Okay, in the back there.
Mike, it's a long series, but can you talk about getting in an 0-1 hole and how tough it is to come back?
Well, I think you said it right there. It's a long series. We just played a shorter series and lost the first game and came back. So, you know, we'll turn the page and come out tomorrow, and we're going to have to obviously do a little more on the offensive side to pressure these guys. But we've always responded well from a tough loss and come out and play a good game. I'm sure the same will be tomorrow.
Who else? Okay, Don, right there.
Mike, you know, given your experience in the division series, can you kind of relate to Ron Gardenhire's decision to go back to Guardado in a one-run game after, you know, Mays had only thrown 98 pitches, just to kind of stick to your plan? What does a manager think there?
Well, I think, you know, just from the outside looking in of the way Ron runs his club, Eddie Guardado is going to be in there in that situation. I think that he has a lot of faith in Eddie. I think anyone would. He's an incredible pitcher. He does a great job. He pitches well in the clutch, and I wasn't surprised at all to see that. And I'm sure that Ron wants to get him out there as much as he can. And obviously, the way we're looking at it, we hope he's not out there as much as he can, because that's going to be a lot of save situations for those guys.
Couple more. Anything? Okay. Where? Let's see. Okay.
Obviously, your team fielded the ball pretty well in the Dome. Your impressions of the Metrodome and the playoff atmosphere?
Great atmosphere. I think the place had a lot of electricity in it. I think obviously the fans were into it. They looked like they were reacting to every pitch, and that's I think it's a great playoff atmosphere. We didn't have any problems tonight with any balls that went up, I wish they weren't cheering as much, you know, tonight. That means we would have done a little better. But I thought it was a great atmosphere. We'll come out tomorrow and hopefully get done a little better than tonight.
Mark.
Mike, when the fan ran on the...
All right, there it is. Mike Socha talking in the Metrodome as we look towards Game 2 tomorrow night, which is live again on Fox, KTTV Channel 11 in L.A. and XCTV Channel 6 in San Diego. All right, Ramon Ortiz against Rick Reed. Now, that's the one question I would have asked at this news conference, guys. Will you go, because we talked about this last night, will you go with Ramon Ortiz, who got bombed, 3 home runs and 7 innings in his one show at the Metrodome earlier this year, or, Mark, do you pull the trigger now, like you were saying, to go to Washburn?
I would like to pull the trigger and go to my horse. This is a big, huge game tomorrow. And I think when you have a big game like that, you need to go to your number one pitcher, and that would be Jared Washburn. Even though he's coming on 3 days rest, that would be the only thing that would keep me back, but I would have to go to him.
You could also make the point that Washburn is the more seasoned veteran. Ortiz may be more likely to be shaken. You're obviously going to be playing game two on the road, game three at home. Maybe bring the kid back for the game at home. Pitch your Washburn, your left-handed veteran, on the road.
Well, I agree. I mean, that's the one intangible that Jared Washburn has, is that he does have the big game experience. He's pitched a lot of big games down the stretch for him. He did a great job in the Yankee series. He'd be my guy. Ortiz is a guy that can come out tomorrow and absolutely flat-out dazzle. That's in the back of Mike Socha's head. He's seen him pitch extremely well in the past. He's got confidence in him. Maybe a lot of people don't, but he does. That's his guy. He's going to him.
Ramon throws more home runs, gave up more home runs than anybody. He's a Burt Blyleven used to do that, too. I mean, he is a home run high ball pitcher, and he gets tagged a lot. Do you take that chance here?
Well, sure. I mean, Mike Socha's going to. He's already made it, told the media he's starting him. But you look at Joe Mays. He got torched. He went 3 2/3 inning against Oakland, and they handed it to him. They plowed him all over the yard. Comes in tonight, shuts him down, totally, completely opposite of how he pitched. Ortiz, very similar. He went 2 2/3 and got torched in Anaheim against the Yankees. Now they're counting on him to step up. He could do the same thing. Stats tell the certain picture over a length of time. They don't tell the day-to-day action. If Ortiz is on, he can go 7 shutout innings, and that's what Mike Socha is looking for.
I think it's also important to note that when you say he got torched, part of the torching was that he walked 4 guys in 2 2/3 innings. If Ortiz goes out with a different approach and goes at these hitters, here's my best, see if you can hit it, might be a different story without all those runners on base.
Well, that's the key. You got to get ahead, and you walk guys. In Little League, you get torched,
yeah,
if you walk them. Hey, same difference here, except when you walk them and put them on, now the hitter knows that you're wild, got to come to the baby. There it is, and boom, that's how they score runs.
All right, Rex, we're going to hear more from you in a moment. Let's take you back to the Metrodome and hear from Twins manager Ron Gardenhire.
He had his curveball, he had his slider, and he had the strike zone in and out. So that's what we envision with Joe Mays right there, going right at the hitters, making them swing the bats, going right at them, attacking, and that's what he did tonight. It's a pretty good performance, I would say.
Next question, Mark.
Ron, what was it that made you keep faith in Joe after he had a rough outing last week?
Well, I didn't really ever lose faith. I mean, you know what I mean? He's one of our best pitchers. Always, he was an all-star last year. He had an elbow injury, you know, after spring training. If you'd have seen him in spring training, he was throwing a baseball pretty good. And then he came out with a little elbow injury, lasted a little while. When he came back from that, there was a few outings there where he was really good. And he matched up against some of the best pitchers in the game and threw just like that, like he did tonight. He had a little bit of a rough start out there in Oakland, but he knew what he had done wrong. He didn't attack the strike zone and didn't attack the hitters. He likes pitching at home. He's very good here. And he was pumped up for this.
Next question. Anybody else? Back there? Way back?
Ron, you were in this position before, but just comment on going up 1-0 in the series.
Well, you know, when you have home field advantage, that's a nice feeling to get that first game in front of our people. They were very excited. The crowd was fantastic. Our players were very good. That was a great baseball game. Both pitchers pitched very well. Their bullpen came as advertised, solid. Got them through. We end up using Eddie at the end, but Joe Mays carried us. So we had a couple of chances to score some more runs, but Appier threw the ball very well. But Joe Mays did what we thought he could do.
Over here.
How much was going back to Eddie about giving him some confidence, and how much was it just out of normal necessity, I guess?
I don't know if there was necessity. All I know is when we talked to Joe Mays, he came off after the eighth inning, and we gave him the option. I said, Andy, ask him how he's doing. And JoJo said, well, either I can try to finish it or Eddie can. Well, that tells me right there, when a pitcher says, yeah, I want it, you got the ball. Because I would have given him the ball. I saw him out there in the eighth inning when the guy ran out on the field. He was stretching, and he told me he had a little harder time getting loose in the eighth inning. So I was really happy after the fact, after talking to him when Eddie was out there, that we had put Eddie out there. But I gave him, he had the option to go back out there for the ninth. I thought he was throwing the ball pretty good. But I'm never unhappy to put Eddie Guardado in the game. Eddie is our pitcher.
Go ahead.
Hi.
Did you know that the commissioner was here tonight? And if so, is there any added satisfaction in winning in front of him?
I actually got a chance to talk to him, meet him before the ball game, shook his hand. He's a very nice man. I had never talked to him face to face. He was very excited to be here. He's very excited about baseball here in Minnesota, the way it's going right now. He's happy for our baseball team. I said before, I believe that he was doing something that he thought was the right thing, and that's talking about contraction. The biggest thing he did this year was that they got a deal done, a labor agreement. That gives Minnesota a chance, and I'm happy that he was able to help in that, getting that done. So it was really honestly nice for me to see him and meet him for the first time.
Here's what we're looking at for game two. The Angels have a shot to get right back in it. And still, if they win this one, they take home field advantage and bring it back to Anaheim. You can watch it on KTTV. Channel 11 coverage starts at 5 o'clock. Angels and Twins going at it in game two.
Frustrating to waste that kind of a performance by Kevin Appier.
Appier was typical Appier. He's going to battle you. He's going to make the pitches. He's going to stall the game a little bit. He's going to make his pitches count, and he did. He pitched a great game. Heck, he went the same amount of innings against the Yankees. They got him for 3 runs. He held them down to 2. That's Appier. That's all you want of a starting pitcher. Hold him down. Get your offense on the board. Let them score some runs. But I'll tell you, you ask him, he wouldn't change a thing. Use his defense. Had his split finger working. Fell behind an awful lot, though, tonight, Langley.
Yeah, that's a problem that Kevin Appier's had that we've seen recently. He is throwing way too many pitches too early. And when you get behind a guy's, you're flirting with disaster. And he was able to make some big pitches and get out of some jams. You don't like to do that time after time because sooner or later it's going to come back and bite you. He made some huge pitches when he was supposed to. He did his job. He kept the team in the game. That is his job, is to keep his team in the game for as long as he can. And I thought he did a great job. The bullpen came in solid as usual. Tight game, what more can you say?
Yeah, Appier did well, but not as well as Joe Mays, the Twins starter. He is now at the podium in Minnesota. We go back there.
And I didn't strike out a whole lot of guys. That's the type pitcher I am. That's the type of guy I was last year. And hopefully I get back to that that form where I can go out there and establish strike zone early and get a lot of ground balls.
Don?
Joe, how much video did you look at of the Angels-Yankee series and what they did against the Yankee pitchers? And did that give you any idea of what the Yankees couldn't do or what you needed to do to shut them down?
We just had some advanced scouting reports. I didn't check out any video. I got to understand that I have strengths, and that's what I got to stick to. Even though I see different things on film, I got to be able to go out there and stick to what I know how to do, and that's sinking the ball away and able to throw the off-speed pitches when I do fall behind and able to throw a little wrinkle in there whenever I needed to.
Mark.
Joe, can you just describe the feeling of being out there with that crowd and, you know, them obviously Gardy showing the faith in you to give you the opening night start, that whole thing?
I don't think there's one word to say how I feel out there. Overwhelming. It was way too much. I mean, it's just so much energy, so much enthusiasm in the crowd. And to be able to go out there and give them a good game to watch, I think that gives them the reward. And hopefully, you know, we see the same thing tomorrow night.
Yeah.
Joe, yesterday you mentioned in reference to the Oakland outing, you used the term bringing the old noggin out and overthinking. Where'd you put the noggin tonight?
I didn't have one. It was on AJ's shoulders. So many times AJ's been telling me to go out there and stop being so mechanical, going out there and just trust what I do have and have confidence in it. And that's finally what I did tonight. I put everything behind. I set my head on the up in my locker, and I went down there and pitched a game of that I feel like is the game of my career.
Mel.
Joe, you knew you were going to get another chance to pitch in the playoffs. Did you think it was going to be game one, or is that the type of is that the type of decision that you thought was going to happen, or did you think it was going to be later in this particular series? Or
I was prepared for anything. Whatever Gardy was going to do, I was ready to go out there. If you wanted me game one or if you wanted me game five, I was prepared to go out there whenever he needed me. I was prepared to do whatever job he wanted me to do. And I knew, like I said, when we was playing Oakland and we lost here, I knew I had a chance to go out there and just give me another opportunity.
Okay. Back there. Joe?
When in the eighth inning, were you tightening up at all, and how did it feel turning the ball over to Eddie in the ninth, considering how he did just the other day?
Well, we had that long seventh inning offensively, and I sat on the bench a little bit. I walked around. I tried to stay stretched. I mean, they brought a guy, you know, a couple guys in there in that inning. So it was a long inning, And after the eighth inning, I went out there and I was able to get the guys out. And when I came back in, Andy asked me how I was feeling. I said, I feel great. I said, I go out there and close this out if you'd like me to. I said, but Eddie's been doing it all year. That's his job to be the closer. So I gave him the option. Because of the simple fact it took me a little longer to loosen up in that eighth inning. That's the only reason I gave him that option. Otherwise, I would have told him I was ready to go back out there.
Just two more here.
You just mentioned the term game of your, right here.
Sorry.
Game of your career for tonight. Can you just kind of put in perspective or what it means to you after kind of all the highs and lows of the last year, from All-Star to injury list to last week of just the journey?
It's just, the whole time the thing is I never lost my confidence. I knew what I had to do in order to get myself back and to get myself back on where I needed to be. And, you know, going from being an All-Star to going on the DL, that was the toughest part. I mean, because I had to show up here every day and do all the little things and do all my rehabbing and then have to go down there and watch a team where I couldn't compete. And that was what the toughest thing was. Now I get a chance to go back out there and compete like I did in the last month and a half of the season and kind of get myself ready for the postseason. And now I get that opportunity, the first one. I mean, I think I was just a little nervous. I didn't have the stuff I had tonight, and it showed.
Well, what are you going to do? The guy throws what he calls the best game of his career. Four singles for the Angels tonight. That's it. A one-out single by Erstad in the first. Kennedy and Eckstein with those back-to-back two-out singles in the third. And then Fulmer, a two-out single in the fourth. And that was that.
All right, final thoughts from you guys going into game two. Now, there's not much Mike Socha can do. It's not a question of having to change the lineup or play little ball or do anything. You just wait for you guys to start hitting.
That's it. But let me tell you what, Joe Mays, he picked the perfect time for his career game. That's exactly when you want to shine, when the whole world's watching. You got to credit that guy right there. But if the Angels want to win this series, they're going to have to be able to bust pitchers like that. That's how you win games. You beat good pitching. Mike Socha will tell you that. Hey, Mays was awesome, so was Guardado. But Gloss taking a call third like that, nice slider, hittable, about belt high. Can't sleep or you'll go home.
I don't. Yeah. It is not a must-win, but is it important? I mean, the Angels don't let anything faze them. But would 0-2 in this series faze them?
You know, I think given the extent of the series going to go longer now that they got the seven games instead of the five, it's not must-win. All of a sudden, there is pressure though. Tomorrow is a pressure game for them. Rick Reed tomorrow is the same kind of pitcher that they saw tonight. It's a guy that changes speeds, a guy that will use both sides of the plate. So tomorrow they're going to have to come out with a little different game plan, maybe a little more aggressive. It's hard to do a lot of things different. You don't want to change a whole lot, but they got to make some kind of an adjustment.
Yeah, I think having lost that first game in New York in that series is a good learning situation for the Angels, especially because this one is now a seven-game series, and you know they reeled off three straight against the Yankees. They have time here against the Twins without any panic in them, I think.
Coming up tonight at 10 right here, we're going to have a full report. Southern California Sports Report, you're going to hear from the Angels in their locker room what they had to say about this. Rex will be back. Mark will be back.
Yeah, I'll tell you about the Kings. The Lakers and Clippers actually played tonight. Did you know that? We have that coming up for you at 10 o'clock. For Mark, Rex, John, Barry LeBrock,
the monkey.
And the monkey.
Come on.
See you again later.